room talking. I think one of you has left your own room. Hey, we're taking you back, Carlos. Yeah, I can hear myself. Is my audio coming out of Jillian's laptop?
I think they're on.
No, I'm all muted. I'm all muted.
How about now?
Test 1, 2, 3. Test 1, 2, 3. I don't see you lighting up when I'm talking.
We'll keep going. The I think you gave two of the special devices to two of the
just one.
Was it just one, or I know we did at least one.
Yeah.
I don't remember if Novar gave his to somebody as well.
I think this is working.
Remind me what we're talking about.
You were in the room last time.
We had the balls. We had actually left. The last time we left off, we were leaving with the guys. It was like the next day or whatever.
Not yet.
Okay.
Still the same day. You had dealt with the guy in the morning, the afternoon. Kind of midday-ish, you spent it talking in the rooms.
Yeah.
Now it's going into the evening because you're going to be leaving the following morning. Or whatever you plan to do.
Yeah.
There is a gentleman that walks up to all your rooms, like a bunch of them, just... They all knock to your room. And let you know that the king would like to see you on the balcony.
Sure.
And you're all escorted up some stairs to a balcony that oversees the city. You can see him, as you're walking up, you can see him giving a speech. Our enemies... Our enemies are short at hand and will soon be crushed. I have devised a plan. And with the help of a new formed group. And they are here. As he waves you guys over to the balcony. As you approach the balcony, you can see that there are a lot of people down below.
Yeah, that's like the entire city down there.
Please give your applause to our new heroes who plan to take on the mission at hand.
That's safe.
To introduce you to decline to comment.
That's not our group name, that's the band name.
This is the name you have given. Like I said, decline to comment here.
I'll walk up and raise my hand.
And you can hear the people cheering from below.
I thought our like adventuring group name was Down with Dictators.
Are we trying to piss everybody off?
He is.
Why?
No, just that guy.
He gets a side. The king kind of side-eyed you for that comment.
You have a death wish. I think there's someone with a death wish among us.
They will carry a heavy burden on their shoulders. They are very much prepared.
No, we're not. It's a lie. No preparedness. Prepare to die.
You can kind of hear a small decline too coming from the crowd. They're just cheering your name on.
Fuck. You haven't even heard us play yet.
Decline to comment fans.
Everybody's going to know our name far and wide.
You're killing me. Yeah, but we didn't even perform here yet, did we?
Our performance is going to be dealing with the situation.
Actually, didn't you guys perform?
You performed for the king.
Oh, true.
Yeah.
And then you called yourselves to kind of comment in front of him.
Mm.
So you just took your group name as Decline to Comment.
I mean, potato, potato. Tomato, tomato.
How many guards are up here?
I'm going to say about 5 on each side.
Hmm.
No. I know you're thinking of doing something. I notice a glint in Navarro's eyeball. I'm like, don't you dare. Not yet.
Well, I'm just going to go to the front and like put my arms up and do like fist pumps.
Give him hype. Shake my head.
You can hear the crowd cheering. King goes, they will embark on their mission soon. They return, you will know that we will be free from the tyranny of the machine.
The machine empire.
We're all going to die again. This is going to be another stressful adventure.
Guys, he turns to you guys. Let us feast tonight.
On what?
Also kind of.
I thought we were heading out today.
Heading out tomorrow morning.
Well, yeah, well, but like we want to head out early tomorrow morning. We don't want to go to bed late.
Or fuck around too much, if you know what I mean.
It is up to you if you choose to finish eating early. But I do wish to at least feed you well. For who knows what perils lie before you.
Oh, many perils.
Yeah, there's always perils.
Many perilous perils.
Far and wide.
Every day, all the time. It's never an easy day for us adventurers, is it? Oh, always running into some sort of BS. Ugh. Didn't get very good sleep last night.
Did not your entertainers make sure that you were properly... I will make sure that they are handled if they are not properly...
No. They did just fine. It was just me. I was tossing and turning a lot. That's just on me.
Well, they are meant to comfort you.
No, and they did. It was great. It was fine. I just got this one little portion of my back that just hitches up here and there, and, no amount of massaging can really fix it. You know, it's one of those things. It could be the weather. What's the weather like right now? I look up at the sky.
Well, there you're brought up to a beautiful another banquet with all the foods in the center, a variety, as you can hear music being played.
Why are we doing another banquet?
If we were able to eat for tonight and then go out in the morning. I guess we shall feast.
Do I have a chance to whisper to Kron?
Roll sleight of hand. So you can whisper without nobody hearing you?
Well, I mean, if I see, if there are people around us all the time, I'm probably not going to bother.
There are soldiers around.
Mm-hmm. Never mind. I'm good.
As you're sitting in the banquet, the king goes, "We have some new information we've acquired. This may help you. We hear that the machine, there are what we believe may be creating those warforges. The buildings have a smoke pipe that may be able to be used to your advantage. If you can get close enough to it, of course.
What? What was it again?
A smoke pipe.
Smoke pipe.
Or yeah.
Okay.
Or like a chimney like thing. Yeah.
How big is it?
About, I believe the reports say 1 foot by 1 foot.
Oh, okay. So it's easy to carry.
Huh? Carry what?
The smoke pipe.
No, no. It's like a chimney that comes out of their buildings.
Oh, we're supposed to attack that?
It's an exhaust pipe.
Okay.
Like, you know, on the Death Star.
Oh.
It's what's in freaking Helldivers. Machine things. You throw
proton torpedoes
down there. Grenade. And it blows up the thing.
Okay, so we're supposed to target that. All right, I got it.
We have a holy hand grenade?
Something like that.
Oh. So we throw the grenade into the thing. Okay, got it.
We were able to acquire about 9 of them for you.
Nice.
Cool.
Oh, so as
2 soldiers walk in with a chest and put it on the floor.
It's a chest to chest.
I'm going to take a look.
I guess we'll have a couple more besides the ones we already have.
Yeah. Open the chest. What do I see?
You see what looks like a stick. And at the end of it, almost it resembles like a grenade.
So a bunch
but
of...
with a long string.
Okay.
With a long string and the circle piece is attached to the other end of the stick.
Each one.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm going to take...
So like,
it's different from the previous
old
one.
Old school grenades?
Yep.
Gotcha.
I'm going to take 2 of them.
So just pull the pin out and throw it.
How many seconds do we have till throwing it?
Let's see here. I think the last guy before he died, we counted roughly 10.
So 9 seconds.
We think so. The guy who was taking count kind of blew up.
Novara's going to take two of them.
Got it, but like we can also hold on to the string and just chuck it and then pull the string while it's in the air.
Yes. Be as creative as you need to be. Just want to supply you with what you need.
These are grenades. These are different than the other things we got then, right?
Yeah.
Right.
All right. So do we each take like nine? Like two of them?
Yeah, there's nine.
Okay. Nine of them, and there's five of us. So four people take two, one person gets one.
Okay.
Sure.
Who wants how many?
I'll just take one.
Okay, so then everyone else will get two.
You're going to give the NPC two?
No. There.
Oh, yeah.
There are... There's five of us. Math. We have nine grenades.
All right.
What's a math?
What is a math?
What is this math you speak of?
I show my hands. I start like doing the hand thing.
Oh.
They're counting.
Yeah.
I just put down two grenades. Oh.
What sorcery is this?
Do we get to know what these grenades do before we use them, or?
I think they just go boom.
Mm-hmm. Is it the extra?
Like, how much of a boom?
Well, if you're asking the king how much of a boom, well, it the feet were left from the guy who was still holding it.
When did you get it from Amazon?
Oh, okay. Okay. Good to know.
Yeah. As he grabs a giant turkey leg and starts biting into it. Now, there's a soldier that runs in real quick and kind of whispers into his ear. He nods, and then the soldier walks away. Well, let us continue this night. If you need to go to your rooms to sleep early, that is fine with me. Is there any other questions from you?
I get it. We go make robots dead.
Exactly. This will majorly cripple their invasion into these lands. Unfortunately, it will not fully get rid of them, but at least it will slow them down.
Wait, not fully?
No, unfortunately, no.
That's unfortunate.
Yeah.
You're just taking care of one of the outposts that are near us.
Do you have any idea why they're here in the first place?
Unfortunately, no. They just appeared out of nowhere. And began pushing in. Several towns have fallen.
I see.
Several towns. Jeez.
And now they've made their way almost to us.
Any advice? Any tactical, know-all for this?
Do try the stealth approach.
That's my okay. specialty.
Totally.
Are you wearing plate? He just looks at you sideways. Aren't you wearing plates?
Exactly.
Super stealthy.
No, not at all. But it's fine.
Navar does a chuckle.
Roll up there and die.
Face palm right now.
He grabs his drink, raises it. To decline to comment.
I'll do the same.
By the way, would you guys happen to have any weaponry you can give us?
Give us the bombs.
Other than the bombs.
We've equipped you with one of our super weapons.
Yeah,
we have super weapons.
The super weapons and these grenades. I think we're fine.
Alright, let's go fuck some shit up then.
Well, enjoy the dinner, enjoy the food, enjoy the entertainment, and enjoy your nightly entertainment as well.
Yeah. Well,
the music starts to play loudly around you.
Do I have my regular kit on me?
You have whatever you've been carrying on you.
All right, cool. Is it a buffet or are they serving us?
No, it's a full buffet in front of you guys. Different foods on different plates.
Okay. I'm going to have my share of taking some so I can use it later on our journey.
Okay. Darcy, you just eating?
Yep.
Yeah.
Grab like an amount of food and then just go back to my room.
Is there any bread or something that looks like I can take it with me?
Yeah, that's what I've been trying to get. Just get bread.
There are like cut up loaves of bread.
Okay.
Anything else that's like, not perishable?
Like baguettes. Yeah. The rest of the stuff will spoil over time.
I'm going to take some bread, stuff it in my pack.
Yeah.
And I don't care if anyone sees me. I'm just going to do it.
Yeah.
Same.
All of us standing there. Stuffing bread.
I put it in my bra.
Okay. That's convenient.
Big blocks. Titty pockets.
Titty pockets, indeed.
I gotta get one of those.
I will make a plate to take back to the room with me.
Oh yeah, I'm gonna bring back two plates, including all the food I can get, and also a little bit of wine in my satchel, as it were.
Yeah, I got two water skins. I'll fill up one water skin of wine. That sounds good. One wine, one freaking water.
Yeah,
I will.
They're just watching you grab your water skin and just
pour. I won't eat anything in front of anyone. Like, I'm grabbing whatever food, I'm going to bring it back to my room, and I will cast Detect Poison and Disease.
Yeah, that's what I was going to ask you about.
Yeah.
In your room?
Or whichever room no longer has a mirror in it.
Your room.
Was that my room?
Yeah, you removed it out of your room.
I thought it was my room after we cleared it out.
I mean, I probably would have taken the mirror out of my room as well, but like, yeah. I was pretty sure it was his room.
Okay. All of you guys are heading back to your room?
Yeah, I'm holding three plates.
I'm gonna fill my water skin too.
Detecting poison disease, so I know if there's any poison in any of it.
I'll be heading back into my room with my servant.
I'm going to Kron's room first.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll happen there to see if any of it's poison too.
You all head into his room.
I went to my room.
Okay, you went to your room.
You're going to die of poisoning.
I'm feeding the servants.
They're going to die of poisoning.
They thank you for the food. As they begin to eat. Nothing happens to them.
Oh, okay.
Your detect poison or just anything on the food, nothing. Other than the chicken being a little over-seasoned, that's about it.
No such thing.
Just dry.
It is only under-seasoned.
They added too much salt.
Well, just eat it with some potatoes. It's fine.
Well, other than that, no. The only thing that I need Lily to...
What am I doing?
To roll perception.
Okay, just regular perception. Yeet.
Nothing seems out of the ordinary to you.
Shit. Okay.
Carlos, yours are in your room, by the way.
They're already there? Okay, I thought I was going to get a knock at the door again. So.
Well, you went over to his room.
I thought they were... Okay, your which one has doesn't have the mirror?
I thought they were following us around.
Well... Oh. Ah, shit, yeah, that's right. They were following you guys around.
Yeah.
My bad. They're with you in that room.
Okay. I each give them a plate at the table and go, guys, hungry?
Yes. Yes, please. We're starving.
Okay. Yep. Eat up. So what information do you guys have for
me? What do you need to know?
Well, did you hear that we're all leaving?
We hope that you safely return back to us.
Oh, neat. So that's a yes. You did hear that we're leaving, or did not hear that we're leaving?
Yes, and you are to depart tomorrow morning.
Did you hear any murmur of ill content towards us?
They are betting to see how long you survive.
Who's they?
The soldiers.
Soldiers. Anything from, say, the king's personal guard or, say, his court?
We were not able to get into that room.
Okay.
We do know that... that they will be meeting the same day that you are leaving.
Okay.
Who did you give the bomb to again?
I did not.
Crom servants. Crom gave it.
Crom.
One of Crom servants.
I think it was one of mine.
Okay. When did you? He's chewing and trying to eat, trying to talk at the same time. When did you want me to use this again?
After we're gone, really. The first time the king and all of his advisors are in the war room together.
Oh. He just passes it over to the girl. That would be you. They only allow women to serve them.
Yeah, that tracks from what we know of these people. Anywho, we all have a big day tomorrow. We should get rest.
And
be ready.
Oh, Is everybody going back to their rooms?
Yeah, let's stay in Kron's room if you don't mind.
Yeah, I don't care.
Yeah, my crew.
Slumber party.
Yeah. Let's do a jump high five. Yeah. That would be awesome.
But no, like, I'm obviously used to living in small quarters with a bunch of people.
Right.
Like, just reminds me of home.
Yeah.
Lily, when you go back to your room,
mm-hmm.
you realize that there's nobody, your group is not with you.
Well, that sucks.
And you get a knock on the door.
Okay. Is there a peephole I can look through?
No. You have to open the door.
Nah, damn. I open the door, crickety crack. Crack, crack, crickety.
Two new people.
The fuck?
They're like, we're here to entertain you tonight.
Yeah, it's cool, but what happened to the other people?
Huh?
The other people I had last night. We just snuggled.
We do not know who you speak of.
I had other people last night, and I was very happy with them. Why are they not here tonight?
I'm sorry, I don't know anything about that. We were just told that we were here to entertain you tonight.
You know what? I'm gonna go ahead and entertain myself tonight, so don't you worry about it.
You want us to watch, or just...
You know, no, you can, you know, go ahead and, you know...
Leave?
Do your own thing. Be free. Do your own thing.
You just close the door on them?
Well, I'm just like... Can I do an insight check on them just real quick before telling mm-hmm. them to go away?
They seem very nervous.
Nervous.
One of them puts the hand on the door and go, we really want to ensure that we entertain you properly tonight.
Okay, and why is this? We've
been told to ensure that you are good for tonight, and...
Okay.
Don't you remember what they did to him last time?
No. What happened last time?
He sent him to the pit.
Oh, yeah, that's true. Okay, all right. Yeah. Okay. Fine, come on in. I'm going to sleep. You can just kind of hang out there. You know, talk amongst yourselves.
You don't sleep on the floor.
No. Here, let's throw some pillows together for you or something. I kind of make them a nice little bed out of pillow, like extra pillows and stuff.
You're able to make one bed.
For them both?
They will just do as they can.
Okay. All right. Just, yeah, you can kind of hang out. I mean, it's cool. Just, I need to get some rest tonight.
Do you require a massage?
No, it's just my back's acting up again with this little thing. I'm totally fine. I'll be fine.
We will make sure that we attend to your back issue.
Okay, fine. I mean, if you want to just like see if you can, you know, get that knot out, go for it. It's a little rough back there, though.
You see them struggling a bit.
I know. It's pretty bad. It's the weather. There's something going on. There's something afoot in this weather. I appreciate you trying, though. A little tense, that's all.
So now they, let's see here. Zalan, you went back to your room as well?
Yes.
Your guys are eating? Finishing up eating, actually. They ask you, what would you like for tonight?
Same as I like every night.
Then it shall be done.
You go over there in the corner and you watch. You in the bed now.
and crawls up onto the bed. Now, Carlos.
Yes.
You went to your room as well, right?
Yeah. Right now I'm getting feedback from them, figuring out how the best way to be buddy-buddy with the soldiers that are coming with us, because they have information on both of them on it, because they weren't able to get to, like, the court, but they were get information from the soldiers. I want to see how I can buddy-buddy them so we don't get backstabbed.
There's not much they can tell you unless you want to give them, like, a hand job or something.
Wait, I have to fuck them for information, even though their purpose is to fuck me?
No.
He's saying they don't have the knowledge.
They're asking you about the soldier. You're asking them about how to handle the soldiers, and this is what they know.
Oh, okay. So in other words, it's something other, like, we don't know anything other than pleasing them sexually to make them happy. Got it.
Exactly.
The way you phrased it was, I had to give them a hand job for information.
And I ask you, how would you like to handle tonight's? How would you like to handle tonight?
Well, I just want information. I want to know what you guys know that we're up against, how it is, and if you guys can somehow, some way get
me information. There's four of them in that room.
We have four of those fuckers in there?
Yeah, yours and Kron's.
Wait, what?
Kron's that's great. Room. Yeah, that's true.
I thought we were all in Kron's room.
Yeah. That's how we got our food checked.
I know, but you went back to your room with all four.
Kron's. I would have not have done that. Like, wait, no.
If Novara is also spending the night in my room, I wouldn't be opposed to having my two also be in the room.
Yeah.
It was just if I'm the only one sleeping in my room, I don't want those other two in there.
Exactly.
So if
what if we
just send them to your room? All the servants just to your room.
You could send them to me.
Oh man.
Lily.
Oof.
We could just have a snuggle party, I guess. Why not? No? Okay.
I thought we were doing the slumber party in Kron's room.
Yeah.
We could all sleep together. It'd be great.
I'm sorry, I was under the impression that some people were going back.
Everyone wants to sleep in my room, whatever.
Yeah.
That's fine.
Yeah.
Alright, so we're all sleeping in Kron's room?
Sure.
Yeah. So then is he getting busy in the corner while everyone watches?
Don't mind the noises.
It's definitely a con room.
Oh, true.
Oh, it's
giving me flashbacks to Ramen Con 1 year.
Oh, boy.
Fuck!
Not that time. No. The time with Kyle and Kyle.
Oh, you were with Kyle?
Yeah, when Kyle...
Okay, I'll mute this.
Oh, Calception? When he didn't drop
back while we were all in the hotel room?
I wasn't there for that, Vlad.
I think Uriel was there.
I probably stopped by.
Some anime, and then somebody looked over to Yeah.
Kyle squared.
Yeah.
All right. So,
I also thought we had the same people attending to us.
Performance for me, just Curiosity.
Whatever I get, I'm adding a 6 to it, just so you
and
know.
And then roll for sleight of hand.
And so 14.
You all hear it.
I hate my life right now.
Oh, we hear him fucking?
Yeah. Yeah, you do.
Okay.
The fact.
Fuck is right. I believe that's what that sound is.
Why?
So let's keep going here.
Sure. It is the following morning.
I didn't get much sleep because of the ruin laws.
Roll for sleep.
Roll for quality of sleep.
Yeah, what type of skill would that be, Uriel?
Let's go with con.
Constitution?
Mm-hmm.
Saving throw, or?
No,
or just constitution.
Regular constitution. Mm. You get a good night's sleep.
Yes, I did.
Yeah.
Do I need to roll that? Because, like, that's... Loud noises while sleeping is normal.
Get advantage on it.
Okay. Constitution. 17.
So, Meg.
Yeah.
Get the rolls in.
You gotta roll your constitution to see if you slept through all the fucking...
I slept good after all the fucking...
Yeah, you did. Mag, you good?
Dude, I'm trying. Like, it's just... I don't know what just happened.
Do you want me to just roll for you? I'm like...
Nah. Oh, allow. Never mind. Just blocked... I kept blocking everything in sight. What do you guys want me to roll?
Constitution.
Connie saves?
No, just regular one.
From...
Oh.
You had
I don't hear it. Wait, I don't hear it though.
Why don't you?
Is that what you're telling me?
No, you heard it.
You heard it like that.
See, his thrusting kept bumping into you.
Oh fuck. I would have had one of the servants just go, "Hey, can you
The roll's the roll.
Oh, right.
'Tis true.
Let me get a bag of snacks. All right, so the following morning has come up. Meg looks like shit from waking. His hair's everywhere.
Yep.
Feel oddly refreshed this morning.
Fuck you all.
Maybe if you did last night, you would have slept better.
I slept great.
I look at the fucker girl like, I hope it was worth it.
It looks like it.
Sounded like it.
He's all... shiny and grin happy, who knows what. I don't know what word I could use. Wide-eyed and bushy-tailed, is that
bright-eyed and bushy?
Yeah.
The servants go outside the door.
Post-coital glow.
Now, as you get the room, they're kind of like thanking you guys as you leave.
I tell my servant, you're most welcome.
You're brought over to the entrance to the palace. You're not brought to the entrance. You're brought to the back door exit to the palace.
So over on this side of the building?
Yeah, on the back end.
Okay.
You're not gonna come out through the front. You're gonna come out through the back.
That's very clandestine.
You see Bane fixing his pants. That was a lovely couple of days of just relaxing.
Wasn't it though, Bane? Wasn't it?
Bad it was.
I give Bane a high five.
Oh, he returns it.
So we are outside the palace. We have our group of, it was what, 5 guards they were sending with us?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I thought it was more than that.
No, it was just a group of...
So they sent 9 or 10.
It's only a couple.
Are any of the servant people with us?
No.
Okay.
Let's start walking towards the river. And let's see how close we can get to our ship before the guards say something.
I thought we were supposed to use the ship. Well, we told
you to say that we're going to take the boat down the river.
Yeah.
Aren't we?
Travel.
Well, yes, we are. But I don't know if we were supposed to or not.
Oh.
But we are going to our ship.
Yeah, let's just walk that direction. Yeah.
As you get about this far, the soldiers are going, hey, we're supposed to be heading the other direction.
Yeah, we have a ship that'll make it much easier for us to travel that far.
Don't you want to get the job done faster?
That does sound better.
Yeah. We'll head all the way down to our ship here.
They all follow you to the ship.
What is the captain going to allow this?
Oh, I'll talk to the captain, let him know what's going on.
As you approach the ship, you hear, hey, there you guys are.
Yeah.
As he catapults himself off the ship onto your shoulder, Kron.
Hey, Whiskers. We are, we have been tasked to travel north and deal with these Warforged guys. And these 5 guards will be coming with us.
Oh. I see. Do we?
Yeah, we can discuss the details in your cabin.
Of course. Is there any chance that the cargo needs to be lightened a bit?
Nah.
Okay, just checking.
It'll be fine. We'll find out.
Oh, you let me know.
Yeah.
As he kind of moves his, like, nose left and right.
I know what you mean.
Well, gentlemen, we are happy to have you aboard. All right, set sails, everybody.
Where are we going again?
North.
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 Once we're, like, out of sight of the city, I'm going to talk to the guards after, like, letting the captain know, like, the everything that's going on. And just, like, I'm going to ask the guards, like, hey.
Let's pick the spot first before we do this in the ship.
Well, yeah.
Are we going?
Make sure we're a good ways away from the goddamn
city. Yeah.
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 And then should we do it below deck?
No.
Yeah, but they could jump off the ship.
That's the idea.
Oh.
I mean, the option of them not joining us is them getting shoved off the ship.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I thought we were just, you know, on the live.
I mean, if they can take off their armor fast enough, they can swim. Probably.
Bust their armor myself for some money.
But anyway, yeah, like, I'll make sure the captain knows what's going on, so, like, his people are aware of what's about to happen, so it's not just the five of us plus Bane versus the five of them, but, like, the whole crew knows that it's these guys don't join us, they're going over the edge of the ship. And then, you know, just give the guards a whole, like, hey, so we have no intention of going on this suicide mission that the king wants us all to go on. You can either join us in not doing that, or we can push you off this ship and or kill you. And then your options from there are go back to the king and probably get killed for not following orders, or go do whatever you want. I don't know. I don't really care. But if your plan is to just leave and not go back, you might as well just join us.
Roll your persuasion.
That's gonna go well.
Can anyone hype him up?
If they don't join.
Do I have any help from everyone?
Oh yeah, you get charisma. Boom. Bard inspiration. Blah blah blah.
Bardic inspiration.
And you can awesome. Give yourself guidance.
It's true. I can give myself guidance. I would have given myself guidance for that.
Okron, you're doing all right.
I'm just saying if they don't want to join us.
I don't want to fight.
I kind of figured that you were playing like kind of like suspense music. Oops. As he's giving the speech.
Did I roll that at advantage?
What the hell?
I was assuming that I had, I don't know, I had help or not.
What do these numbers mean?
Because, like, I had help from all the people. I don't know if it was persuasion or intimidation that I should have been rolling, but
14 total?
Persuasion. Okay, so then yeah, that and Bardic is a it's a D6, right?
Yeah.
Inspired, inspired you are. So that we may go far.
16.
And then your guidance.
The guidance was built in. Yeah, that was a plus 3. So, yeah, 16.
They kind of huddle up in a group. They tell you 1 minute as they start to discuss amongst themselves. So if we go with you, they ask, is there going to be compensation?
I mean, standard compensation as being part of a crew of a ship.
And your lives.
That too.
Yeah, well, we also share whatever spoils or whatever we get, yeah. Right? Yeah.
Yeah, you know.
You will get a share of the money that we make on our adventures, as long as you participate.
Oh, well, where's the captain?
Plus we...
Where's the captain?
We, yeah, the captain, you know, does the whole hiring thing for people on the ship.
He's there, isn't he?
Yeah.
Probably, yeah. I don't know why he wouldn't be. But then also, when we do eventually get to where we're going, we might need guards, because we do own land.
We do.
Yeah.
If you want to work as guards there...
It's owlbears, right?
It's all bears, not just owlbears. It's just all bears.
Oh. Only bears?
Bears? It... It's Battlestar Galactica?
Yeah.
So. You see them look at each other. You see a bunch of them nod.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck the king.
Hmm.
Good choice.
And he puts his hand out to you.
Take it.
And he shakes your hand as the agreement is made, you do hear a giant explosion.
The fuck just happened? Wait, what day is it?
They might mean in the city. Do they mean
it's Revolution Day?
What?
It's fucking Revolution Day. That's what it is.
Oh, we did it.
Oh, yeah.
We didn't do it. They did it.
Down with the bourgeoisie.
I don't remember if I gave them mine or not.
When we asked, you said you still had it.
Oh.
So there was only one there.
Worth it.
You feel a giant push of air pass by the ship, rocking the ship.
The fuck was that?
Big boom.
Felt like a shockwave from some sort of explosion.
Should we be concerned? I'm completely...
No, I don't know why we would be concerned.
The main concern is that we still have some of these things and they clearly seem very explosive.
Explosive, yeah.
Effective?
Yeah.
And we got some mini explosives too, so...
Yeah. Cause some havoc.
As you start, before you start making your way into the tree line, into the forest,
mm-hmm.
out to the north, you can see what appears to be like a billowing black smoke.
That doesn't look good.
So we should go
as you head through the forest. No, it's north. West?
And we're going northeast, right?
Yeah, correct.
Then we're good.
Yeah, Not our problem.
Yep. They're just gonna go kill everybody down there. It's all right.
Feels like a damn. I thought we were gonna try to talk to the Warforge.
No, no, not our problem.
Yeah, they seem like they have their hands busy.
I mean, if they're an invasion force trying to kill everyone on the planet.
Well, we should have thought about that before we blew up the town, so.
I mean, that was, I don't care about that. That king, I think it was good for him.
Well, you felt the shockwave. You felt the shockwave, right? I think it killed a whole lot more than just the king. I'm just saying. So
that's possible.
This is the keep it moving. It's not our problem.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yuri, I look at our potentially new recruits. How do they look like?
They are dressed in, instead of the royal colors, it's more like black.
Makes sense.
Okay. And how are, like, how's their composure towards this explosion?
They don't care.
They're probably treated like crap.
They don't care.
Can we RP this? I'm going to say to them, how are you treated in the kingdom?
We were always put in suicide missions.
Mm.
We weren't meant to live.
All right.
We tend to just find ourselves in suicide missions for whatever reason here.
Well, yeah.
Now we're avoiding a suicide mission now, so.
I know, but inevitably we're going to get into another situation, be it a giant turkey or.
But we have free will. They didn't basically have free will because they probably would have been killed by the rest of the king's.
Do what you're told.
Yeah, yeah.
Or you get tossed to the pits.
There you go.
Yep.
So you're free now, basically.
Congratulations on your newfound freedom.
Are we, though?
I mean...
You can leave the ship whenever you want.
Yeah, I mean, you could do whatever you want. I mean, we're offering you a job here, but that doesn't necessarily mean you have to take it.
It's something for now, until we figure out what we want to do.
Yeah.
Yeah, because when we make port, if you wanted to leave, you could leave.
Yep.
Gob walks over. I thought you would bring more goblins, not more humans.
Mm-hmm.
You just take what we can get at this point.
And one furball, huh?
Furball?
As he's petting the dog.
Oh, yeah.
Oh. Dog-a-donk.
Right, dog-a-donk. I'm gonna. Do I have anything for dog-a-donk?
Whiskers jumps over onto the soldier's shoulder. Well, we can always need security here.
Yep.
Looks like you guys are very kitted for that.
Also, just so you guys know, this gentleman is vicious, so don't try to counter his whatever he says.
Don't fuck with him unless you want to get fucked.
Yeah, what she said.
He just looks at you and goes, we wouldn't dare.
Yeah, he ate through a person at one point, right? So.
You pulled an Ant-Man on a Thanos kind of thing.
Sure he did. They kind of look all confused at each other, but okay. As you head through the forest, You come as you're exiting the forest, sorry. About here. You see your ship kind of having to get close to the shoreline as another bigger ship passes next to you.
It's not ominous or anything.
They're compensating.
It seems to be a little more fancier.
Mm-hmm.
But they barely managed to navigate not to hit each other.
Hmm.
This is bullshit.
Do we see what the people look like on there?
Hmm?
Do we see what the people look like on there?
The most you can tell from the ship is it has the symbol from the palace.
Oh. Well, if they want to take care of any issues down there, I mean, that's their deal.
As you finally make your way to the exit port.
Is it this big thing?
It's right here.
Okay.
You end up having to navigate into some... I forget what they're called when they got to elevate the water up and down.
Oh.
Dam? Canal?
That's the canal, I guess.
The... Panama Canal.
You have to go through the canal kind of to get out of there.
Yeah.
So you end up spending a couple of extra hours there just, you know, in line waiting to exit as other people are entering. You hear a lot of whispers from the crew, but you can't really make out what they're saying.
They're called lock chambers.
Lock, okay.
I just looked it up. I was curious.
As you make it to the last chamber, there's a guy yelling at you from the port side.
Hmm.
You might want to hold travel for one more day. We hear that there's rough storms approaching.
Oh. What if we go?
If you need to, you can dock over. You can park over at the docks. Other than that, you have been warned.
Can I do an insight check on this dude to see if he's legit?
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's legit to you.
Why don't we go north? See if there's anywhere we can just set anchor.
We could just steer around the storm. I mean, I'm pretty sure we could see the storm and just steer around it.
Captain?
You're calling this one, Cap.
Yeah, it's his ship, anyway.
Yeah.
He kind of yells out, how big is this storm? Any details on it? He just says, it's a big one.
Or we could steer around through here.
I don't know if we want to go back towards the city.
It wouldn't be going back towards the city, technically.
There is no city to go back to.
There is a lot
Why don't we just try and... Okay, hold on. Which direction is the storm coming from?
This direction.
The east.
Okay. It's coming from the east, and we're heading towards the east, so we... How far away is the storm?
It's about to hit.
Okay, so we wouldn't have time to get further out into open sea before it struck?
You'd run into it.
Okay. Fuck it. Let's try and just head straight into the storm.
What?
Look, you don't want to be right at the coast when a huge storm hits.
But I don't also want to go on a suicide mission.
Captain, is that correct? Do we have enough time to reach out beyond
the lock? We have two choices. We anchor down and wait till it passes. Or we just say, fuck it, and travel through it. But I will need all hands on deck.
Or we could always head west.
We won't go faster than the storm if we head west, and we will just be heading into more dangerous places for us to be hit by a storm.
Yeah, like hit
if we go straight into the storm, yes, it's bad, but we won't be right next to a bunch of rocks getting thrown around, and if we're heading into the storm will actually pass by faster.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
If we stay here, yes, while anchored, we won't get blown around as much by the storm, but we are also right next to a bunch of rocks and ground.
Yeah.
And we're more likely to have our hull be damaged.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So.
Sounds good to me. But whatever the captain wants, it's his ship.
Well, Kron, you think we can handle the storm?
I think we can handle the storm.
Your people are good enough to handle something like this?
Yeah, I don't see why not.
Well, sing us a beautiful sea shanty.
I'll grab the helm.
I'm glad I don't have to breathe.
Let's set sail then. So all hands on deck.
We went to the sea. It was great. And we went.
I am going to ritually cast Guiding Hand while I'm up at the wheel. So I make sure I know what direction I'm going in.
What way would that be? The fastest way through the storm?
Hold on, let me actually read the wording on Guiding Hand to see whether I can just pick a point in space that I know exists on a map.
As you approach around the mountains and you start seeing the sea, you can see...
Oh, it's got to be a major landmark.
You could see a very dark clouds that are spinning and lightning just everywhere. You can feel the ship kind of bobbing a bit from the waves. Even the seagulls are flying towards the land. You have a light drizzle of rain right now, starting to hit the ship. So you can't use Guiding Hand?
Yeah.
Okay.
Naming a city that I know is to the east of us. I don't know.
When you just left? Oh, east, forward. Okay,
We want to go to the place where we're supposed to go, right? I assume we know.
Well, you still have some more stops before you get there.
But it's in the east direction, isn't it?
Northeast, yeah.
Yeah, so can't we just use that?
Then, yeah, I'll name that city for the spell.
Okay. The waves are going up and down, and as it gets much more, as the storm approaches more, these waves are getting deeper and higher.
Well, I got this.
You could see almost the ship fighting you as you're trying to navigate it. Can you roll me a dex to... Oh, no, strength to hold it.
Lily, do you want to help him up there?
I shall help! Oh, you're inspired! You're inspired by me and my song, this sea shanty I'm singing, everyone sing along. You're inspired, you're inspired! May your aim be true and get us fast through this storm.
Okay. And, well, because I am proficient in both navigator's tools and water vehicles, I will add a plus two to this on top of the plus two for my strength.
You managed to hold.
Yeah.
Turtle power.
The rain is coming down heavy now onto the ship.
Rain is fantastic.
It will make it a little rough for you to walk around the ship right now.
Mm-hmm.
As it is a lot more slippier.
Do we need to be any key points on the ship that we would know from the captain?
I will lash myself to the wheel. So I'm not going anywhere.
The key points you need to be at are at adjust the sails.
All right. I'll be in that area.
So there are three points for that. The back sail, the middle sail, and the front sail.
Can I stay by the captain in case, or by Kron, so I can inspire him again if need be?
Yeah, that sounds good.
Fine. I guess what about the rest of you?
I'll take one of the points. Yep. So Mag, Zalan, and myself.
Yeah, I'll help Oz. Plus, tell me what to do, Cap.
The wind's readjusting. All you guys will need to do athleticism to readjust your sails.
Sounds good to me.
Do I have to do it too, or am I?
No,
you're with the other. You're with the other guys. Those three need to do it to readjust, and you all managed to readjust.
Plus six, nice.
And the ship just picks up speed. It goes down and right up and right back down, but perfectly so it doesn't damage it too much. You could see that the waves are almost as tall as a mountain. I will need you to do a dexterity now, or... Damn it, what the hell was it again?
Acrobatics?
Yeah, let's do acrobatics for our driver.
Oh.
To navigate through the next giant wave coming through.
Oh, I don't know what.
Acrobatics, huh? Okay.
There's survival skill. I don't know which one would be fitting.
Add plus two to this because, again, proficient with water vehicles.
A very tall wave. The guys have helped you with a nice little boost.
You're saying he got splashed by water or something?
Oh, it's raining. It is raining hard on you guys right now.
I'm just saying for Kron, what was the acrobatics for?
He's navigating.
Oh, wouldn't it be something
different?
I don't know why it would be acrobatics. That's what just what he said, so I accept
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
You need to be inspired again.
And I don't know. I rolled a 19, 17 yep. plus 2.
You perfectly control the ship to avoid having to damage it upon lift, you know, going up this giant wave and coming right back down.
Come on, he's our man. If he can't do it, no one can.
He kind of goes sideways on it to come up and down it.
Mm-hmm.
You can hear the ship. You can hear the ship creaking and trying to sustain itself together. As you come down for a moment, the sea goes calm.
We're in the eye.
As you can see the sun for a moment
mm-hmm.
over you. A hole that wasn't enough. In the clouds.
That's cool.
This is exciting, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know,
much for one on the sea, but this is an experience.
Yeah, as we're all yelling to each other.
As the ship gets whipped to the left.
Ooh.
And whipped back to the right. As the next set of waves are just different. They're not following the normal patterns that you're used to seeing, Kron.
Hmm.
The wind has also become erratic. I will need the three guys controlling the sails to re-roll again to control the ships.
Oof.
13. I will add 6 to mine.
You have to do another athletics prep.
Me? Right. I'm 18.
Illegal. Okay. Are we rolling again? Athletics?
Yeah.
Yep.
Nice.
So,
I thank you.
You two end up holding the. The adjustment to the sails correctly, but Navarre, his kind of pushed him. Oh. Like, he just slid.
I got this.
As his kind of just goes across the ship and some people ducked just in time.
Hey, guys, guards, whatever their names are. Can you help me out here? I yell to him.
They run over to give you an assistance.
Nice.
I'm going to need you. I'm going to need Kron to roll another strength to control the ship to keep it in its same spot because it keeps trying to push you more towards the left.
21.
Yeah, your turtle strength overpowers it.
I'm saving it. Another 100.
You end up holding it in its position, but as you look down, you could see the center of the wheel. You can hear small cracks. Towards the center.
Oh, Lord, we're gonna die.
Mend.
Kron.
Sorry, what?
You hear small cracks towards the center of the wheel.
Good boy.
Mend.
I do have mending. Mending.
Oh, it's instant, so...
He's in his zone. It's 1 minute.
It is 1 minute. But...
Are you going to repair it or drive it?
I have Warcaster. I can do both.
One hand mend, one hand steer like a boss.
even if I have both hands full, I can still do somatic components of spells. So I can cast this spell.
Oh, nice. I was thinking like a lowrider, but yeah.
I'm just, you know, wiggling my fingers a bunch while turning the wheel.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I don't, if you want me to make like...
I knock over and try and help him with the wheel.
Yeah, like, I don't know if you want me to make like a concentration check to see if I can successfully cast the spell while I'm doing this.
And then I can try and go over and supplement his strength, maybe, on the wheel.
Go for that.
Because I can't mend shit.
No, Kron, go ahead and do the concentration.
Okay, that's a constitution saving throw at advantage. Because Warcaster.
Oh.
Oof. Rolled real bad.
Lily, do your things work before or after? Or it doesn't matter?
And I what?
Or would it apply to that?
Yes, I said it before he rolls yours.
I thought some people had one that can do afterwards.
Well, I can choose to use the bardic, a bardic inspiration after I roll.
Oh.
Before I'm told whether I fail or not.
Oh, okay.
But even if I rolled a 6, I don't actually know what the required amount of constitution I would need to do this would be. So if I do roll...
You just wouldn't mend it. Above. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm like, I guess I'll roll that bardic. 3. Does a 9 work? Is that enough concentration for me to...
You just barely made the concentration.
Okay, so then yeah, I will mend while I'm driving.
As you saw the cracks start to form on the wood, you start to repair it. You can feel that the ship's trying to turn you, but you're able to hold it with your one hand right now. I need... Whoever would like to roll a perception.
He's got highest perception.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'll do it.
Since all of you guys are on the top of the ship.
Would this fall? Oh, I mean, yeah. I have a +5 to perception.
Oh. You're busy, though.
Yeah, but I mean, I would still be looking around. I am navigating.
True. I mean, up to you guys.
Anybody can roll.
I already rolled.
What's my perception? Oh.
I got a 14. Novar got a 15.
All right. So nobody else is rolling?
Oh, you want everybody to roll?
Yeah. I allowed anybody to roll.
Because we are all above decks, so we all have the option of being able to see.
True.
Okay.
Ooh, 17.
So Meg, Kron, and Avar. As you're looking up, Kron, especially you realize that this storm isn't normal.
Well, all right, then.
The three of you notice a familiar face in the storm.
Face?
Whose face?
Is it the dude from The Mummy?
Is it Thomas?
Is it
The Rock?
Is it Go-Go?
Or is it Go-Go.
No.
Oh, Lord, she's a coming.
The fuck?
This bitch.
Why the heck is
only Gina? You three notice this.
I yell out, Go-Go!
Yeah.
Go where?
Go, go,
go. Where are we going?
Go.
Go, go. Where are we? Wait.
Morning. Go.
I know I'm a lady, but where are we going?
I'm pointing out. Go, go.
There are two giant waves to the left and right that are closing in on you. I need you guys to see if you can control the sails to pick up the speed. Mm-hmm. And I need Kron to, we'll continue with Dex to navigate out of there.
Okay.
So let's get the speed guys first.
20.
Oh, shit.
All right, Zalan slipped.
I'm going to add a six. Hold it.
Inspire.
Inspiring!
5, so that's 13. I mean, if you added inspiration...
Yours moved a quarter back, but you were able to hold it. So it moved you out of position a bit. And now, Kron?
I'm going to cast Guidance on myself, because that is just a one-action casting time. Am I just using, like, acrobatics or
straight dex? Yeah, you can use acrobatics.
Yeah. I'm just going to do acrobatics, because that's easier, because to automatically add in the +2 for proficiency, because I could just check it and then uncheck it when I'm done. Oh, thank God. So a grand total of 20.
How do you get out of there? You see these two giant waves coming in on you. The speed of the boat has picked up as well.
Just straightforward, just ignore what's to my left and right, because can't fucking think about that. Just go forward, forward, forward. No deviations to the left or right.
As you're just speeding on forward, you can see that the waves have hit behind you and closing in like in a circle over the ship.
My God.
As you just make it out as a circle closes.
Hmm.
Oh, good God, we're going to die. Oh, that was close. I don't like this.
Give a big old middle finger up to the sky.
As you see the storm behind you slowly dissipate.
Wow.
And the sea... The sea is waving still a bit after the storm, but... It seems pretty calm from the distance you can see.
I say to Zalan and Meg, did you see the face in that thing?
Yeah, I did.
I was too focused on the sail.
Oh, it looked like Go-Go.
Yeah. I think it was Go-Go. I think she's the one that also blew up the last kingdom we were in. Anywhere she goes, it's disastrous.
True. Must have been.
I guess she tries to destroy everything, I guess.
Soldiers kind of go, what do you mean exploded?
What? Who said what?
The soldiers that are with you.
Oh.
Oh, the weather. Look at this, dude.
That rush of wind earlier.
Exploded to chaos.
I don't know.
All the chaos.
Wait, are you talking about the performer?
Yeah, she's evil. Yeah. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, she's bad. She's
just a singer.
No, she's not.
No.
Just a singer? Oh, she's wait till I tell you, Mitaela, whoa.
Super vision.
Well.
Yeah.
It was a dark and stormy night.
She's like legitimately evil. And has a grudge against us because we have a grudge against her. I don't really know how that works, but like, you know.
She doesn't believe in consent.
It's fine.
Yeah, I point at Lily. Tell your story, Lily.
I have her autograph.
One day, on a dark, stormy night, I went to the cemetery, and I went to meet this lady. I was all afright. And as I passed the gates and into the tomb, I went. This woman came up behind me and in my hand placed a dent. And upon my hand I bled and bled, from which she took my blood and signed a contract of which I did not want to. And that's how it ended up in the hood.
Mm. Are you going to turn this into a song?
I was trying to. It was okay.
I think you're going Fresh Prince.
Yeah.
Life she sucked my down. Life force dry.
Yeah.
I thought the end was nigh. And yet, I was saved by these very brave humans and turtles.
Tiefling.
People. Yes. Beings. To which I pledge my thanks.
Friendship
forever. And that'd be me, Taylor Woe.
Yeah, so that's Go-Go. And she blew up a school. Right?
Yep.
Yeah.
She doesn't want people being learned. She wants to keep the population down.
I need Lily to roll deception.
To roll deception? It's the truth.
Yeah. Novar believes this too.
Roll persuasion.
Deception?
Persuasion?
Oh, you got deception already.
Well, whichever you wanted.
That's fine.
I feel like persuasion is more fitting.
Yeah, I mean, I don't know. You should have probably the same score in both of them, right?
There you go.
Three.
Oh no, your deception is actually better.
It might have been one of her selected
deception and only plus three in perception.
One of them kind of has a sad face as they look at her autograph. Thought she was a good person.
Mm.
Fuck no.
No.
I'm pretty sure she's not a person either. I believe she's a demon.
Yeah.
Demons are people, too.
She's a gorgeous demon.
It's because she's cast a spell on you without your consent to think she is pretty when really she isn't.
Yeah.
That's what they do.
You've seen
Well, we don't know that part, actually. Yeah, she could be actually hot. We don't know if she actually has a glamour on her or not.
Hmm.
But we do know.
Why are we giving her the benefit of the doubt? She doesn't deserve a benefit of a doubt.
Yeah, I mean, how she looks doesn't change how she acts.
Yeah,
so.
like how she looks doesn't change anything. It doesn't.
She's an ugly person on the inside. That's for sure.
Yeah, I feel like it would
100%.
Be
100%. She is 100% pure evil.
Yeah,
on the inside, for sure.
And I think it'll be reflected really exteriorly as well.
You can only hope.
One of the guys grabs his autograph and just throws it out the ship.
There you go. I'll pat him on the back.
He's free from her evil clutches.
Yeah. It's better this way.
He was my motivation.
You can find it better.
You can find it within yourself.
Declines a comment. No backup.
Yeah. Decline the comment. Yeah,
we're all nodding with you. We're all nodding with you.
There you go.
Whiskers kind of goes over to Kron. Good work, and then good work to everyone else down there.
We didn't die.
I say to Kron, did you somehow fix something while you were steering at the same time? It felt a little off, but then it felt perfect.
Oh yeah, look. Sometimes you just gotta use magic on the fly.
Nice.
You gotta double fist that magic, that's for sure. Yeah.
I say to Lily, if you ever want to write a song about this, no Kron's part in this.
Oh yes. I'll get working on it in my head right now. Kron, so great. We escaped a dreadful fate because of his double-fisting magic powers. We get to live for longer hours. Oh, Kron, raise his name in pride. Kron, he got us to the other side without death. We did okay, and now we live to see another day.
I clap.
Whiskers is clapping, and so is everybody else on the ship.
Thank you.
Well, Whiskers goes over to Kron. To Porta Vista.
That sounds fancy. And hard to pronounce.
All right. That's the city that I had my guiding hand heading towards?
Yes.
All right. Then just keep on going that way.
You find that it took you roughly 3 days to get there. In those 3 days, not much has occurred since the storm.
Ooh, so we're all rested up and I get all my inspiration points back?
Yeah.
Oh, yay.
There's been a couple of dolphins swimming next to the ship along the path. And
nice.
Everyone's done their duties on the ship. Bane shot somebody over cheating on cards.
Ooh.
Almost.
I hang out with Dogadonk.
Where are you patting the dog?
Huh? I said hang out. I'm teaching him tricks and stuff. Like sit, roll over.
Do animal control to see how well you train him.
Yeah. 22, perfect.
He has learned what you taught him.
Yes. Badonkadonk is smart.
He will now follow the sit command, stay, paw, roll over.
I rolled 20 with me speed.
Nice.
But he does now attack you with his butt.
What?
Of course.
Wait, who?
He'll walk backwards.
Oh.
And attack you with his butt.
Like who? Why?
Anybody.
Why would just he do it?
Just cause.
Oh, okay.
He's picked up a new skill.
Yeah, I guess.
Butt attack.
True.
Tail whip. No? Okay.
He must have channeled it from
the morning. You wake up with his butt towards you.
Oh. Well. Dogs be dogs.
Now, Kron, you see the island that you're approaching. It is beautiful. You could tell from the sea, the layers of the city. Like every wall takes it up another layer.
Like Gondor.
Like what?
Like Gondor.
Or Space Grease.
No. Yeah. Like Gondor.
No, not Space Grease.
You have to walk either to the left or right to go up. To to get to that next layer of the city.
Or, you know, the Renaissance Center. I guess I could have just said the Renaissance Center.
Okay, that place is confusing.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it is. Who the hell's at the... Who's at the door?
Me.
That would be really funny.
Huh? Here, I gotta go see what's at the door. I'll be right back. One moment.
I say to the crew, do you see Dog-a-Donk? He can sit, stay, paw, roll over. Pretty cool, huh?
That's cool.
Hey, he seems to be learning a lot.
Yeah. But he's also started learning this attack or something.
An attack?
Yeah. Backs up into stuff. It's different. Say that. What'd you say?
Tail wag attack?
Yeah. I mean, it could be useful.
Yeah, it could be useful in a fight.
Maybe it will lower their defenses.
True. I don't know where he got it from, though. It's kind of unusual.
Mm-hmm. Too much late night TV, I guess.
Yeah. Big booty goblin TV. Yeah.
Probably it. Gotta be it.
Mm-hmm. I would say to Kron, did you see the cloud earlier? I mean,
yes.
Did you see the face on it?
Yeah, that was definitely late a good go.
Yeah, that was scary.
The fuck? Lady Could Go.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you didn't see that?
No.
See, I thought
you were just telling us to go and go.
Oh, no. I was trying to... I didn't know what to say, so I was just saying the name.
So wait, she was in a cloud?
Her face was in the cloud.
Huh? She's
I
a
think
cloud
she
now?
Made the storm or something. No, she's probably some type of technique or something. Magic.
That bitch.
Yeah.
And consent to her storm.
Mm-hmm. But Kron got us through it, so.
Kron indeed.
We all got us through it.
True.
Yeah, it was a team effort in some ways.
Yep.
I feel like I could have done more, but. You know.
As you approach the port and you dock there, you are greeted right away with people with some necklaces made out of flowers.
Mm-hmm.
Like a lei?
Mm-hmm.
No. This is kind of nice.
Welcome to our town.
Howdy ho.
Whiskers kind of lets you know that there'll be about a day here for them to handle their business.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
It's a very relaxed environment here.
Okay.
So feel free to explore the city and just enjoy yourselves.
Sounds good.
I feel like anytime we go and explore a city, something else.
Yeah.
These soldiers were asked by Whiskers if they were going to work on the boat or not. And the soldiers agreed to it for now.
Oh, do we get any money from the captain?
No.
Okay. Darn. I've got 4 gold to my name.
Oh, jeez. Oh, right. Y'all spent money.
Yeah, upgraded my Axe.
Yeah, that was the day that I took a nap on the ship while y'all went shopping. Mm. So I still have my, 47 gold.
I'll show you my axe. It's a masterwork axe. Great axe. Check it out.
Nice.
Shiny.
As you walk around the city, you realize that you guys are kind of overdressed.
Oh.
Everyone's wearing very thin shorts or pants with either a see-through kind of shirt or a very thin shirt.
So I fit right in.
Yeah. But the rest of you guys that are wearing armor and stuff like that kind of stick out a little bit.
Do you remember the name of this place, Alvin?
Puerto Vallarta.
Okay. Like VIA?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Greetings.
Hello there.
What do we see?
Who are we greeting?
Just some random person.
Yeah, just a person's happy. They're just walking around smiling.
This is a nice place.
Yeah, I wouldn't mind staying here for an extended period of time, actually. Rest and relax.
I got some stuff I could sell.
Oh.
Got fancy clothes and freaking swords and.
You guys need to know where the clothing shop's at?
Yeah, is there a collection of stores?
It's on the first tier.
Oh.
You're on zero tier right now. So you gotta go up to first tier.
Sounds good.
And what does that mean exactly?
You definitely need to change your clothes, sweetie. You see people like either walking barefooted or just with like looks like sandals to you.
I
like to remain armored.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Is it super hot, or is it bearable?
It is humid.
Hmm.
And it is hot out here.
But, I mean, is it uncomfortable to be in the clothes that we're wearing?
If you stay in them in a certain amount of time, yes.
Oh.
It will be very, you will be very sweaty and very sticky.
I'm going to put my armor and clothes and stuff in the ship. And just whatever undershirt and such that I have.
Okay.
I'll wear. I'll also leave my weapons. Let's see. I'll keep the staff with me. From the Fox Girl.
Do you all head up to the first tier?
Yeah.
I suppose I'd ask if there's like a weapon shop on the first tier as well, or if that's higher up.
Are you just asking a random person?
Or whoever told us about the clothing shop.
She just looks and goes, what do you need a weapon for?
When we eventually leave?
I don't think so. Okay. I mean, no one here needs a weapon. It's relaxed.
I mean, okay. Sure. All right.
Yeah, the only ones that carry weapons are the guards, and they're just chilled.
You guys don't get many adventurers here?
Yeah, people come and go. That's about it.
Can I, like, do an insight check on these people?
Sure.
Huh?
Yeah.
Oh, God damn it.
They're just laid back. You kind of get that vibe that they're just laid back.
Okay.
Neato.
As you make it up to the first tier, you come across clothing stores.
I'm good looking. And try to sell my sets of fancy clothes.
As you go into the first clothing store, you see that it has a lot of shorts, a lot of like button up kind of shirts. Hello, what can I help you with?
Would you purchase garments?
Oh, we look at, depending on the clothes, depending on the style, it might be something we may be interested in.
I have two sets of very, very fancy clothes.
Let me see. Oh, look at these. This is made very comfortably. I haven't seen this kind of material in a while come through here. Is it a nightgown?
It was dinnerware bestowed to me by a king.
Oh, we have royalty here. Well, I'll offer you 10 clamshells.
Clamshells? What about, yeah. You don't have gold here?
We have clamshells.
How about we do a clamshells?
That's our currency.
Clamshells is currency here?
And he puts one down on the floor. He puts one down, and you can see that it has like a certain print on them. Has the name of the island.
It's in the car.
I'm not quite into clam currency, but thank you.
Okay. If you're interested, let me know. I see you have a weapon.
Talking to me?
Yes.
No. You just remember, you cannot go into the second tier. Okay.
Is my stick fine?
That could be classified as a weapon, so I would recommend you put it away if you try to go into the second tier.
Okay.
But don't worry, most of the shops are first tier. It's more like the residents and higher ups are in the next set of tiers, and they just don't want weapons.
All right. Do you guys have a weaponsmith or something on this first tier?
We don't really do weapons here.
Why is that?
On the whole island?
Pretty much. I mean, this is more of a relaxing place.
No one comes here to try to take over because you don't defend yourselves?
Oh, don't worry. The higher-ups can handle any type of invasion.
Oh.
Who are the higher-ups?
We are meant more to relax here.
I pull out some rough patches of leather Do you see these interesting?
Give you like one clamshell for it?
About two.
They look pretty rough.
Yeah, but that's good. That you can mold them and shape them to whatever you want.
Persuade them.
Okay. Let's see. Persuasion. 20. Very versatile.
Kind of stretches it.
Yeah.
I think I can make a speedo out of this.
Oh, yeah. You get very good water movement
from that. Here's one. Two clamshells.
All right. Let me see if I have any. Do you like bread?
I prefer my fresh fish, thank you.
Do you like mutated turkey talons?
Don't see a use for that, no.
You can carve things.
Don't really see much of a use for that in the form the type of store.
I take one out and I motion in the air like, see?
That's very lovely. You can put it away now.
Okay. Well, would these two clamshells buy me clothes somewhere, you think?
Oh, of course.
Is it enough?
Would you like, what would you like?
Well, you do clothes too?
Well, yes. Don't you see? This is a clothing store.
Oh, I just want a full outfit to be comfortable in.
Toss the talon in.
Okay. I give him the two shells and one of the talons.
He kind of looks at you. What are your favorite colors?
I mean, I'm orange, but I don't really want to do double orange. So, pink? Would that match with...
So what he does is he hooks you up with like a high...
Actually, I don't know about pink, but...
A high, like...
Like a salmon.
Highlighted pink?
Salmon color. How's that?
The hell's a salmon color?
Salmon color. Like Shinesman?
How's a Shinesman?
Look it up. Shinesman.
You're making me Google.
Shinesman. Salmon.
Color.
It's like
brown?
Light brown? No. Salmon color is...
Oh, no, that's like still like orange.
Yeah.
Orange, brown.
Orange, pink.
Pinkish, okay.
Yeah.
So he kind of goes and gets you a shirt that looks like that.
All right.
Gets you like a shirt and it has... it's kind of see-through.
Nice. Does that come with pants and shoes?
Yeah, he's giving you like a mat... matching.
Okay, I'll just put salmon
pants.
Yeah.
Shorts kind of with like their sandals.
Okay. The sandals are just like a brown?
No, the same color.
Oh, wow.
It's a salmon with white highlights.
Okay.
Now it looks like you're relaxing.
There
too.
We go. Nice.
And you feel a bit of a relaxation to you. You don't feel as worried as you once did.
Okay.
You don't feel as stressed out as you've been.
Dude.
You feel more like just relaxed.
Vibes. Yeah, I'm all about the vibes. Yeah. I do.
Vibes.
Did we train a special technique like maneuver earlier? I think it was for a band or something. Didn't we do like a Ginyu Force type thing?
The pose.
Yeah, I thought we did.
Kind of.
I can't remember what it was though.
You did it during one of your performances.
Yeah, so I'm gonna do it.
Okay, strike your pose. Yeah.
Yeah.
Looks good, man. Looks good.
There we go.
He looks like an anime character.
I'm orange and green hair, so I'm in already.
Pretty much there.
Yeah.
Well, you look relaxed.
It is very relaxing. I suggest picking up an outfit.
Hmm. Okay. Sounds nice.
What about everybody else? What are you all doing?
I'm hesitant. I don't understand a place like this.
I'm just looking around, seeing what other type of shops I see around.
All right, so you're done with this place?
Yeah, I'm not getting no clothes here.
It's nice. What do you mean?
No, I mean...
We don't need to spend a whole lot of time just a place where there's nothing fun to do.
Look at the D&D chat.
I see that.
Wait, with the
is D&D that the guy we're talking to?
Yeah. Why I'm not Ken.
He seems happy.
Feels nice and conflict-free, that's for sure.
Yeah. And he also likes horses.
All right, so you guys move on to your next shop, which is another clothing store.
I'm doing that as I walk, the slide thing with the arms out, and then I switch to the other side. Let's do the slide thing, if you can imagine that.
All you guys notice that Navarre has a little more of an up to him.
An up?
Up.
Okay.
Yeah. Navarre seems a little off.
Hey, I'm standing here.
Are you wearing Earth clothes?
Wait, what? Am I wearing what?
Cursed clothes.
Cursed clothes.
I'm gonna virtually cast Detect Magic on those clothes.
I mean,
are they magical?
Yes, they are.
Magical, right? They are. Yeah.
What school of magic?
A good question. What does charm fall under?
Enchantment.
Enchantment then. But okay. It's not a control one. It's meant to relax you.
Calm emotions?
Mm-hmm.
Gotcha. Well, there's really no harm in it, but like,
it'd be hard for the barbarian to rage in them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is that a bad thing?
Well, I wouldn't wear it if we're going somewhere where we need to fight or might need to fight.
That sounds like a challenge.
But if you want to wear them? If you want to wear them on just like your day off,
okay.
Do it.
We get days off?
It's a day off.
We spend days on end on ship. That's a day off from adventuring, essentially.
I wish I had more shells.
There's always the chance that we get into a fight on the ocean, but the odds are against it.
While you're inside this shop, you also realize the rest of the clothes in there are also enchanted.
Do you embroider stuff or screen print?
We do a bit of embroidering. That's custom work. It will run you a clamshell.
Let me see if I have anything that I could trade. Do you want another one of those?
You're in a different shop.
Oh. I show him the talent. I show him the talent. See this? And I swipe it through the air. Like, see how it can help you do stuff?
I can always say it's a tooth of a dragon or something.
Yeah, yeah.
So what do you want to embroider?
I wanted to say bad man on the back of my shirt.
Bad man. Now, do you want it like when you run your hands through it, it changes color?
Sure.
Okay.
Do you know the reference? Anyone?
Yeah.
Okay.
You're wearing a pink shirt with bad man.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, give me like an hour or so to get that done.
It's Vegeta, by the way.
Yeah, I don't know.
You're not going to pinch him then, you know.
You end up leaving your shirt there.
Okay, I'll just put my other one back on. My undershirt for what I assume I was wearing an undershirt under my armor.
She looks at you kind of like, you do realize that doesn't match anything you have on?
Well, that's all I've
had. It's better for you just to leave it off.
I'll think about it. And then I put my arm up to my neck and like flex my muscle. and I guess I'll wink too. I should have asked what she looked like first.
It doesn't seem very impressed because you're not matching.
Oh. Wasn't it a woman? It's not a woman?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I thought you said.
Yeah, but when you put on that other shirt, okay.
They don't care. That's fine.
Yeah.
Man, this place is rough.
Zalan?
Yeah.
It's just another shirt place.
A lot of shirt places. I don't think we're going to find anything of interest here. Unless everybody is looking for clothes.
It's nice clothes.
I do not need island clothes.
Why not?
Anyone else? Lily? Meg?
Well, again, I'm not feeling the vibe here. Like,
I go up to Meg, you know, and I put my arm over his shoulder. Come on, man. It's just have a good time.
You're acting weird, dude. You're acting a little weird.
How is this weird?
I don't know. It's stressing me out, though.
Dude, we can't have weapons. I'm not very content with that.
I mean, we don't need to stay here. This is just a stop.
Yeah, we're only here overnight.
True, but every time we think we're going to be in a place overnight, then it ends up being a week, and then we have to get pulled into their shenaniganery, and then we're fucked.
Then we can always walk right back to the ship.
That's couldn't do that before in the last town.
Well, I can't even go into the second level because I got a weapon, so I'm not planning on going up to the second level. So,
I think we gotta head back to the ship and take a nap.
Can you take my staff back with you?
Do you think that's a wise idea?
Yeah.
Fine, I'll take your damn staff.
Thank you.
The food is in the second tier.
Ooh.
I guess I will head back to the ship with Lily.
If you have anything that I can trade, so I can get some clams, shells,
and
I can bring food for you.
I think you're having a problem.
A problem? You don't want food?
I have my breast bread.
Okay.
That's the food on the ship.
Yeah, but it could be really good here.
Trust it.
I could always try to catch a fish off the ship.
Whatever, sure.
All right, so them two are heading back to the ship. What about Meg and Kron?
I have weapons on me, so I can't go anywhere. But we could stay in level one with weapons.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, how thorough is the check for weapons?
Well, as you're walking along the first tier, you can smell, like, you're getting a whiff of grilled fish.
Dude, we have no
and a whiff of salmon. This is an angel. And something being fried. Now you can't put your finger on it.
That smells good. You two down?
The food's all on the second tier?
Yeah.
You can see the stairway that leads up to the second tier.
We can always bring them some. I just need to get some shells.
Can I hide my mace in my shell?
I don't think there's enough space for you to do that.
I don't know. It fits me.
Do a sleight of hand to see how well you hide it into your shell.
Okay. With guidance. 13.
Okay.
Probably sticking out a bit. Would I would know that it's not super hidden. That's below my passive perception.
Don't worry, they have to roll to find it.
Yeah.
So you'll find out once you get up. Meg, what are you doing?
Well, I can hide some of my shenanigans with me.
Hmm?
Fair enough. I'm going to go with the guys.
You're going to do what?
I'm going to go with the guys.
Radical. That is bodacious.
You're going to try to hide your weapons?
Yeah.
Yeah. The security look tight?
Well, roll your sleight of hand.
Okay.
See if you can hide your stuff.
Sleight of
21.
All right, so as you make your way up, you see that there are guards watching people pass by. They do stare at both of you up and down. All three of you. Up and down. Since you're not kind of fitting in.
I tell them I'm getting my shirt embroidered.
Tailored. Okay.
Yeah. I can take this one off if I have to.
You kind of stick out here, you know, and so do your friends.
Should I take my shirt off?
It would be best recommend.
Okay. I'll take it off.
Just don't cause any problem.
Yeah, right? Do you have any tips on getting shells so we can get some nice food?
You could do some local work.
Like dance?
Not sure. You can see if somebody will hire you for dancing.
No. Okay. I thought that's what you meant, but wasn't sure.
There are some local in and out stuff that needs to be handled here and there.
Like carrying stuff. Yeah. I can carry stuff.
We'll have our eyes on you three, but don't get out of line now. Do not, and I will repeat this well, do not go into the third tier.
What's in the third tier?
That's residential.
Oh. What's, no one goes in there, even though it's residential?
The residents go in there.
Oh.
You are not residents.
True. What if a resident wanted me to go there?
They would have to walk you in.
Okay. Makes sense.
And of course, stay out of the fourth tier.
Oh, there's a fourth tier?
Yes, that's more of the people who run the place.
Mm. What if one of them wants to talk to us?
They can talk to you down here.
Oh, okay. Good to know.
Only personnel is allowed up there.
Mm.
And we do have a kill on site.
Oh, geez.
Policy.
Hmm.
Just figured I would let you newcomers know so you don't find out the hard way.
Makes sense.
Other than that, enjoy yourselves here.
I do my Ginyu Forest style thing as a, yeah.
He kind of does his pose, like putting his hands and then crossing them and pointing it up.
Nice. Cool moves.
You too, bro. And he kind of gives you a fist bump.
Radical. I'll do the thumb and pinky thing where you shaka. Yeah.
Kind of looks at you confused because he's never done that before.
Oh. Dude.
He puts his fingers and starts doing that, like, yeah, kind of mimicking, yeah, you.
See, that works nice, right?
I like it.
Yeah.
Enjoy the restaurants at this.
Thanks. Shall we?
As you're walking by, the first ones are just offering shots of seaweed. The next shops have a variety of different seafood.
I look at Kron. I assume you want seafood?
I do love seafood.
Yeah. We'll check that one out.
You find different fried seafood at this spot.
Mm. You do any trades, I say to them?
I don't know about trades for food. Mostly we like the money.
Yeah. Do you need any help carrying anything? Moving anything? I'd flex. Can I do a roll for this flex?
They tell you that they one of their shipments is at the docks for some fresh fish.
Oh, that would take a while.
If you're willing to take care of that, they'll get you a meal.
Now look at the guys. How long do you think that would take us?
I mean, we're here all day, like.
Yeah.
Okay.
That sounds good.
So you guys are going to handle that?
Yeah.
He tells you what ship.
All right. Just bring it back now, right here?
Yeah. Now we're going to go over to Galleon and Lily. Galleon and Lily are...
Yeah.
Galleon and Salon.
Yeah.
And Lily. You guys are walking back to the ship.
Okay.
As you run across a little girl who's crying,
Why is this child screaming and crying? I just want a nap.
She's in your path as you're walking.
Why is she right there?
I suggest you go find your mother, little girl.
Can you help me find her?
Doesn't seem to be my problem.
What does it want?
Just want to find my mom.
Why?
I lost her.
Why?
I went to go play in the sand.
Why?
I like the sand.
Why do you like the sand?
Because it goes through my fingers.
It's coarse and rough. It gets everywhere. I don't really like sand.
It's fun.
No, we don't know this area. You should probably go ask one of the guards. We don't know this area.
I haven't seen any of the guards down here.
No?
If you go right up to where the freaking, where you go up to the next tier, they're right there.
Can you walk me there?
Nope.
Tired and conflicted. I don't know what to do.
Can you help me? She looks over at you, Lily.
Why do you, bud? No. I just want a nap. Ugh. When was the last time you saw your mom?
She was next to me and then she was gone.
How long ago?
The sun was like right there.
Does that make any sense to me? What she pointed at the sun?
You just pointed straight up.
Has the sun moved from that spot?
Not really.
Didn't you ever think your mother didn't want you to find her?
Oh, Jesus. Salon, that's a little rough.
She starts crying again.
I don't want to get involved. I don't want to get involved. And yet I feel like I need to get involved. Where were you? Okay. What's your mom's last words to you?
Stay close.
And you fucked that up, didn't you? All just right.
Like sand.
Are you from this island normally?
Mm-hmm. We live up there.
She pointed to the third floor?
Yeah, she's pointing up to, like, the area where all the residents are.
We don't really live here, and I think it would be weird if I followed you somewhere.
Yeah, your mother just probably didn't want you no more. It's all right.
Stand up! You're not making this any easier, bruh.
Starts crying again.
Damn it, get Zalan! The fuck? I look around. Do I see anybody, like any guards or anything?
No, you'd have to go back to the first to see the guards.
Wait, what about the guards on our ship?
Well, what about them?
Are they there?
They're at the ship.
All right. I walk over to our guards on our ship and I say, hey, I'll pay you a gold to take this child up to where it needs to go.
We're on duty right now.
And you're on duty that I'm saying you're doing this instead.
Did you talk to the captain already?
Somewhat.
Whiskers is in his office if you want to talk to him.
go inside to the office.
By the way, Zalan, did you stay there or did you go back with her to the ship?
I'm going back to the ship.
Okay.
Mr. Whiskers, there's a small child outside that lost its mom, and I'm tired and I don't want to deal with it. But at the same time, I feel morally conflicted. What should I do?
Maybe the kid wants to become a crew member. Who knows?
Oh, you just let the kid out there, didn't you? Nice. Okay, fine.
Yeah.
Mr. Whiskers! Captain Whiskers!
Mm-hmm.
I need your advice.
Well, you got a choice.
I know I have a choice. But what would you do if you were in my situation?
I'm sober, right?
Who's sober?
Me?
Whiskers? Yeah, I don't know.
In this situation, am I sober or not sober?
I'm gonna assume you're sober because it's during the day.
Probably had a couple drinks. See, the difference is whether or not I would help.
All right, fine. Well, would you help or no?
If I'm sober, yes. If I'm not sober, no.
Okay. Well, I don't know what to do. I feel conflicted.
Where's the child now?
It's outside somewhere. Somewhere out there. Mm-hmm.
Sounds like the problem just solved. Sounds like the problem solved itself right now.
Sure, if you want. Yeah,
I guess so. All right, I'm gonna go take a nap.
You go take a nap, but you have a hard time sleeping.
Why do I have a hard time sleeping?
Because you're conflicted.
Ugh. I don't want to be conflicted, though. Ugh.
Galan, what do you do? Galan.
I'm going to go try to go fish. Off the ship. I'm going to go fish.
Use survival to see if you catch anything.
Then
you reel it. You try to reel it back in, but it gets away.
That damn fish.
The rest of you guys are walking back over by the dock area, and you manage to find the ship.
All right.
It's almost like a small tugboat, kind of.
Go up to the first person I see near the boat.
What can I do for you?
We're here to pick up the products for, and then say the guy's name.
Oh, yeah, that guy.
Yep.
I got about three barrels for him here.
No, we got three people. Sounds good. Do you have a cart, though?
Oh, no, you're going to have to carry them up there.
All right.
Sign off here for him?
Sure, I'll sign it.
It's already been paid for, so...
Yep.
No need to worry about it. Just signing that you're the one responsible for it.
Yep. Thank you, sir.
He stamps that. He stamps each one of your boxes or each one of your barrels.
Mm-hmm.
I will need everybody to do a athleticism to pick them up and take them.
Okay. Son of a monkey's uncle.
That's a one.
Athletics.
What the flipping crap?
Fucking hell.
Two, one.
God. Ooh, both of you just pulled your backs.
My back. my chest is so slick. My chest is so It's like from sweating, I guess.
But Meg, you managed to pick it up.
As you see the other two strain.
Wow, Meg.
I'm looking to
your boss.
Yeah.
You want to try one more time?
Oh, yeah.
Pick it up.
Ooh, breathe. 9.
You're having a hard time lifting
it. Holy crap. Maybe it's these shorts. I'm just too calm.
Kron? You try to lift it?
Yeah. Another athletics.
Yeah.
Yep. Navarre was struggling. You finally managed to pick it up.
I'm the odd man out here. What the heck? Maybe if I pulled my shorts off.
You do that?
I do have my other clothes still. But I'm going to keep them on. I go rage mode. Can I rage?
You cannot rage.
Okay. Can I roll for potential rage, though?
Nope. You're too relaxed to rage.
Are you saying I don't have the ability to rage when I'm relaxed?
Mm-hmm.
I feel like this is another level of power. I can reach down deep. Does my hair start going yellow? No. Should I just roll again?
Roll again.
7.
This isn't going well for you, is it?
Yeah. That starts to make you weak.
You can hear him grunting and straining trying to lift it up.
I'm strong. I'm the boss. Better than this.
I feel like this might be easier if two of us just tried to carry one crate at a time.
No, I can do this.
Okay.
Do you try to rage again to pick it up? Or do you, what do you do?
Does Mage, no, wait.
Mage Hand will not be able to pick it up.
Yeah, Mage Hand can only carry, what, 10 pounds?
Okay.
Yeah, this thing's heavy.
I guess I'll just do it again. I scream. I do like the... If you ever seen Bloodsport with Chong Li, the bad guy, he takes his two fists and slams them down a few times. Screams. That's what I do. 11.
That's violent.
You managed to pick it up, but you're straining to move it.
Okay.
Like you're moving it. You're just.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
The rough lift.
Right.
But you're waddling it out of there.
Okay. And I'm raging the whole time, in voice, not in actual rage. Wow, guys, this is fun. It's not too bad. No comment.
As you guys walk back to the shop,
Waddle, yeah.
I need Meg and Kron to do a perception.
Fuck.
Kron.
Good. Thank God.
you notice that Navarre's clothes are slowly melting.
Like his new clothes?
I just have the shorts on. Okay.
I'm not going to say anything.
As you hear him, like, trying to carry the bat.
I'm screaming it in a relaxed way.
Oh, in a little. You're still.
Yeah.
That would sound like sex.
I'm in. Okay, I'm enjoying it. Not in that way, but I'm enjoying the challenge. The challenge of it.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Right.
You do notice that it's partly. His shorts have slightly kind of melted a bit.
Oh boy. It's like those, what are those chaps with like the butt out?
Oh, assless chaps?
Assless chaps.
That's what they're slowly turning into.
Yeah, I will not say anything about it.
Okay.
Right.
As you continue forward, you make your way to the first set of stairs and just How do you want to handle the stairs? How about that?
Which person?
All three of you.
The wider the stairs.
How wide are the stairs? It fits about five people across.
Okay. We could theoretically go up at the same time.
Mm. Teamwork! Strike a pose.
Sure.
All right, so each one of you is going to go individually with it? Or, I mean, all together?
Oh, yeah.
With your barrels?
Oh, well, yeah. I rolled pretty well on that one, so I'm good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, then I will need Navarre to roll a how's the other one?
Acrobatics?
Not lose control of his barrel.
You cut out for a second, what did you say?
Acrobatics to control the barrel.
All right. I am attempting to control the barrel. Three.
He hit his foot and has the barrel has started coming back towards him.
Uh-oh. Guys, I'm
Dude, just split one.
Split?
Both of you see him tilting back on the stairs.
See ya.
Nothing?
I don't know. They're not saying anything.
No, well, I don't know what to do. I don't know how to help you. I'm like, dude, ease up. Like, just take your time.
What do we roll to stop him from falling?
You're going to have to do a strength check if you're trying to grab him.
The barrel will be in front of me.
With disadvantage because he also has a barrel.
The barrel. Grab the barrel, not me.
Sorry, dude. Clothes are like melting, by the way.
He's sweaty and you can't get a grip on him.
Oh well. So that was him going by, but can I catch the barrel?
Oh. Sure.
Okay. What do I roll for that?
Same thing. Give me another strength to see if you can hold the barrel from...
Is this one normal or disadvantage?
This is a disadvantage because you're already holding another barrel.
Okay.
Mm.
11. Well,
yeah, the barrel's going with him.
I just slide off. Oh, the barrel's going with me?
Yeah.
I grip it. I'll take the fall.
Let's do an acrobatics to see if you save the barrel.
Oh, man. This is bad. 8.
Hot damn.
Did you change something in the flip and roll 20 settings?
I haven't changed anything. I haven't touched nothing.
I don't believe it.
You're just having a bad day is what you're having.
All bad rolls.
I'm too smooth to care. Too calm to care. I don't know.
So yeah, you bounced off the stairs. Ooh. And let go of the barrel as it bounces down the first stair.
I'm falling down like a drunk person falls where they somehow survive because they're so limber.
Yeah, I mean the whole it's because all their muscles are relaxed.
Yeah, I'm very relaxed.
They don't tense up and get whiplash. Mm-hmm.
With two orange cheeks out.
Your butt cheeks?
Yeah, it's the chaps. Yeah.
The barrel bounces the first time. You hear the cracking.
Oh.
You hear the stress of it as it bounces.
Like sorry. Huh? I feel like I was totally surrounding the barrel with my arms and my body.
That's what I had you to roll to see okay. If you were going to save it.
Okay.
It bounces again.
Mm.
And on the third bounce, it cracks.
Holy shit. Okay.
And there is now water... That is very smelly of fish.
Mm-hmm.
That is leaking.
Mending?
Yeah, I have to come down the stairs. Hey, Kron, this thing's leaking.
Oh, come down and cast mending on it.
Thank you, sir. Ooh, that was fun.
We go over to the ship. Zalan, I need you to roll again to see if you catch any fish. Zalan?
You got a 20? I rolled.
Oh, sorry. Caught a fish. You caught a good sized fish, too. Looks like a tuna.
Oh, yeah. I ask, Captain, how he thinks I should cook it up.
Well, definitely could use a grilled fish today. So let's see if we can set up the pan. Let's see if we can set up the little stove over here and get it going.
Yes, we good tonight. As I start, you know, helping him set up the grill or whatever he has in his mess hall.
Yeah, you can tell that they're very careful with it because they don't want to set the place on fire. And they have you with one of the other guys pretty much prepping the fish.
Is this tuna from specifically around here, Captain?
Yes. This is from this region. You see how fatty it is?
It's very fatty looking. I don't think I've ever had this type of tuna.
You can see his nose like going up and down. Oh, it smells delicious. And we haven't started cooking it yet.
But do you eat the tuna raw?
Oh, when you're out at sea, you do all kinds of things.
Including each other. I'm sorry.
I'm sleeping. Roll me a constitution to see how you're doing sleeping.
You opened your mouth. Oh, you're doing good. Conscious ain't bothering you at all.
You managed to finally get to sleep.
Oh, thank God. Sleeping so good.
Now you're going to be prepping the food for a bit. We're going back to the guys that are finally making their way up to the last set of stairs.
All right.
Making our way downtown.
Am I rolling again for this?
Yep, you're rolling.
I channel all of my abilities and skill. 23. Finally.
You finally managed to put it over your shoulder and walk up the stairs.
Watch this.
Witness.
Witness my power.
Witness me.
As you make it up to the shop, they tell you where to put it.
Yeah.
Where to put the barrels at. Mm-hmm. And as you're finishing up, he tells you to sit down as the meal's ready for you.
Wow. Sorry, there was a slight leakage, sir.
No problem. We'll fill it up with water and get it back properly. But you took care of the workload that I had for me.
Yeah,
afterwards.
That was challenging.
So thank you. I have prepped you a 5-course meal.
I sit down in the seat and realize, wait a second. Why is it so cold?
You find more of your skin touching the seat this time.
What the heck? Oh. I pulled my backpack. I assume I have a backpack with me. And I pull out my regular shorts or pants. They're probably pants. Mm-hmm. Do you have a restroom?
I believe we have one around the corner over there.
Okay, I'm going to quickly go over there. And as I stand
hurry
up.
Hurry up. Your food's going to get cold.
As I stand up, I take my pants and cover my back. And I run.
As you do that, you kind of get gawked at.
I mean, I could have seen it earlier. Yeah.
Hey, sweetie, how much?
How many clams? I stop. What does she look like?
Hungry.
Oh, what'd you say?
For some tiefling meat.
I stop for a second and then I run.
I got the clams for it.
I give her a thumbs up and I'm still running. Sorry, what?
Huh? Nothing. He's like, it was uncouth. I apologize.
No, I didn't hear it.
Oh, I just said she already has a real special one between her legs for.
Oh. Yeah, who knows?
As you make it to where they have the bathrooms.
Mm-hmm.
You find that there's a line.
Oh, no. Crap. Is there a...
And the,
is there a big thing of trees or brush or something around?
No.
What about two buildings next to each other?
Not something that would hide you.
Okay, I just put the pants on over the assless chaps.
Okay.
Okay, and then I go back to the... food place.
All right, as you make your way to, you're like, boo.
I shrug. Like, hands out.
You guys are served miso soup right off the bat and some salad. And then after the salad, you all get a piece of salmon, a piece of tuna, a piece of, you know, chef choice.
Mm-hmm.
Some rice.
Okay.
You get kind of like a mango rice as your dessert.
Mm. Would it be possible to have a takeout? If that's within...
Did you guys leave anything on the table?
What do you mean?
Well, if you're taking out, that means that you're...
Oh, no. I just meant like an extra for our friends.
Oh, no. He only agreed to serve the three of you.
Yeah, I'm just asking him if it...
Unless you didn't eat something and plan to take it.
No, I would have eaten it.
Yeah, no. There would be no food left over.
Yeah.
If our friends wanted food, they could have come and gotten food.
True, but I wanted to ask anyways. So I was, like, talking to the guy.
Yeah, no, he let you know. It was just the food for you guys.
That's fine.
It's for the work. Well done.
All right.
And then leaves you 5 clams.
Oh. Total? Or each? Each.
No, total.
How much would one clam food get us? Or, I mean, do you guys want it? Do you guys want any clams? No comment?
No.
You sure? You could get some clothes. But they do melt, apparently.
Yeah, let's not buy clothes that melt. That's,
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I guess you can. That sounds like, I don't know, maybe something that's fun behind closed doors, but...
It could have also been me specifically. I'm not sure.
Oh, yeah.
I was screaming.
If you overdo the,
rage.
Forcing back on the, calm emotions, it might just burn it out, yeah.
Mag, you want any of these clams?
Dude, let's just hold off on them. Let's see what we can get. I kind of feel like this place is hard to get anything. I mean, these are pretty good as barters for people that like to travel to new worlds. So I say we hold off on them. Food-wise, I think we're set. The captain's probably stocked up shit.
You don't want to get our friends anything to try?
Honestly, man, I feel the sooner we leave, the better. That's my gun instinct right now.
This place is nice. Plus,
yeah, well, you know what? How about if you want more clams, you whore yourself out?
What?
Straight up.
What?
Dude, you're losing clothes. We don't, and we might as well make the best of it.
I don't want to do that, but I guess you can hold on to these clams then if you really want to keep them.
I mean, I won't say no, but at the same time, bro, like...
I'll keep one. How's that? You keep 4.
Wait, what about... I'll keep one. You hold on to the rest.
Yeah, but I'm going to spend them.
Dude, what does a one clam cost? I feel like...
I bought a shirt with...
With what?
With 2.
Is everything just one clam?
No, there was 2 for the clothes and it was 1 for the embroidery.
Oh. I'll hold on to one. You hold the rest.
Okay, but I'm going to buy food for our friends.
Yeah, if you need this one clam, I'll be with you.
Yeah, you keep it. I'd look at the guy. How much could I get for one clam?
One of these meals.
I'll get two then.
No, get started for you guys.
Yeah, it has to be bagged up for
transport. Of course.
Thank you.
It takes him about a, you know, a good couple of minutes, a good 30 minutes or so to get your meal together.
Mm-hmm.
And he has it in boxes and ready for you to go.
Nice.
Now, as you're there getting that, there's a guy that walks up to you and goes, "You guys are so not relaxed here, man."
Yeah, it's tough.
You need to relax.
You have an idea?
And then he kind of like a smoke goes across you guys. Do a wisdom saving throw.
Dodge. Do a straight up dodge.
Seven.
Wait, what are we doing? Wisdom?
Wisdom. Saving throw.
Saving
all
throw.
All of us?
Yep.
That is my best one.
It doesn't affect Navarre. Not Navarre. Mag. And it doesn't affect Kron. But, Navarre, you are extremely relaxed. Hanging out
with you has been helping.
You are extremely relaxed, and you cannot go into rage.
Hmm. Such a nice place.
Fuck.
Dude.
Talking out, man.
Dude, I give him the shaka.
He does it back to you.
Yeah.
Ha 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 ha.
Gnarly, dude.
What's your buds, man? They're gonna mess up the vibe. Just letting you know, okay?
I know. I can't help though, because they're stubborn.
Man, it's just tight. That's all.
Mm. True.
True. Later, guys.
Yeah.
Oh, your border's ready, by the way.
Okay, oh, thanks.
The food?
No, the embroidery.
Okay, the embroidery. I thought you said order.
The food's already done.
Okay.
It's been handed to you.
All right. I believe that was in the lower level. Do you guys want to do anything else up here?
Nah, I think we can.
Nah, I'm good.
As you head back to the embroidery place, they're just looking and go, what happened to your shorts? Where are your shorts at?
I melted them.
What? Let's see.
Okay, I pulled my pants down.
The shorts look normal.
In the back?
Yeah.
What the heck? My ass was out. I don't know what happened.
I thought we mentioned that.
No, but he said it's repaired.
Dude, your ass never needed fixing.
Hands over the badass.
Nice. I take my pants off and I put them in my backpack, and put the shirt on. But then I put my backpack in the front so the back can show. Check okay. that out. I point to it with my thumb to the guys. Look at that.
Nice.
And the color changes.
Yeah, if you run your hands, it switches the colors.
Ooh.
Because it's white and...
I can't really touch it, though.
What do we call it? What do we call it again?
Salmon pink.
Salmon pink?
Yeah.
So it swaps between white and that on the colors.
Oh, nice.
Depending on which way you... You know,
one of the guys has to touch it because I can't touch it on my back, really.
It's okay.
No?
Okay, I'll slide my hand.
There you go.
Nice.
Yeah, dude.
So, want to get back to the ship?
Sure.
Want to relax on the ship? I think it'd be really mellow.
That sounds good. We got to bring this food back to him.
Yeah, and we don't stop for nothing.
Yeah, because it'll go bad. They won't. Yeah. It won't be as enjoyable.
As you walk back, you notice that as you're heading back from tier one to zero, you can see over the, you know, where the sand is and everything.
Mm-hmm.
And the soldiers kind of stop you and ask you if you've seen a little girl.
Little girl? Nah.
Yeah. She's missing.
Missing girl?
Mm-hmm.
Dude.
Well, come with us. We're going to the dock.
Well, if you see her, just send her this way.
What's your name?
But
the soldier stopped you to ask you if you've seen the missing girl.
Oh, well, you said
this way. Oh, no, he asked what's his name. What's his name? Like, the soldier's name.
Carl.
Okay, Carl. I'll take a note of what he looks like.
Carl, can you give us a description of the girl, just in case?
She's about yay high. Human.
Okay.
That is such a great description.
Yeah, dude.
Well, keep an eye out.
Yeah, we
hair
we will.
Color. Eye color.
Dude, you're too uptight.
Wings. No wings.
We'll figure it out.
Says brown hair, brown eyes.
Okay. And you're going to be stationed here? Tell her to come here for you, Carl?
I mean, we'll be here. We're stationed here. We're just asking if anybody's seen her.
Okay.
Sure thing.
All right. Thank you, fellas.
Thank you.
Have a bodacious day.
Apparently someone's mom got too high and let their kid wander off.
Dude. Can you believe it?
Yeah, drugs.
Ron, your nose picks up the scent of grilled food on the ship.
All right.
As you guys have arrived back to the ship.
Mm-hmm. Yo, we bring food for you two.
For me, as Whiskers lands on your shoulder.
If they don't want it.
Hey, excuse guys, me? By chance, did you guys see a little girl?
What'd you say, Zan?
We saw a little girl. I told her, her mother probably didn't want her anyway. And told her to go find some soldier or something.
Well, that's sweet of you. Where was she at?
Down around past the dock. As I point in a general direction.
Can I see do I see that little girl?
No, you just came from that direction.
Oh, so we didn't see her. Okay, cool beans.
Hey, Zalan, you want this food? I show him. It's good.
Sucks to orphan.
Zalan?
I just got done catching a fresh tuna.
Oh, nice.
I'm cooking it now.
Well, this is more than just tuna. Up to you. Otherwise, the captain's going to eat it.
Yeah. I'll be all right. The captain was really eyeballing this and said this was really good, so I really want to try this.
All right.
Okay. So let's separate out. Let's give you eco ration, see if the crew's something.
I'm going to give it to the captain, and then I'm going to give Lily the other one.
When you enter the quarters for her, you find her sleeping.
Hey, Lily. Hey.
Food, dude, wake up.
Hold on. Roll.
Vibe check.
Vibe check.
I don't think vibe check is a skill.
Don't tell that to Gen X.
Do survival to wake her up.
Okay. 23. Dude, we got food for you.
No, huh?
I like waft it in her direction. Yeah. Look at this.
Oh, that smells divine. What is this?
You want it?
Oh, it smells good. I mean,
we got it from one of the stalls on the level you couldn't go to.
Shit, thanks. Yeah, it smells good.
Yeah, it was a team effort.
Yeah.
Right, guys? No comment.
Okay. Well, thank you for your sacrifice.
That was the time.
Oh, my God.
It's all good, though.
Down on the food. It's really good.
Nice.
This is really good. Thank you so much.
Yeah. I just walk off randomly.
No, bye, I guess.
Radical.
Is he okay? Me thinks something's off.
He's walking away, you just see the badass in the back of his shirt.
Bad man.
What in the tomfoolery shit is that on the back of your shirt?
I point to it with my thumb. Bad man.
It's like bad dog. Like bad man.
Yeah. I think that's what it said on. Let me check.
You can't remember what it said? Do you like take it off and look around?
Oh, Vegeta. Yeah, it's bad man in like one word.
Yep. Okay.
Oh no, that was out of game. I'm just saying that's what it looks like.
All right. Sounds good. It looks pretty spiffy, I guess.
Yeah.
Cost you a pretty penny or
I already walked
gold.
Out.
Oh, bye.
The captain just takes a portion of the food and distributes the rest to everybody else. Zalan, your food's ready as well.
Ooh, looks delicious.
So the food's getting served on the main deck right now.
I just asked Dad how much work it would be to put a dishwasher in because I've spent all day doing dishes.
So everybody is pretty much just sitting down, and I don't know if you guys still have space for more food. Getting a portion of the tuna. And some vegetables.
That was delicious.
The captain lets you know that you'll be setting to leave tomorrow morning. They figure they just spend the night here.
I got two clams, guys. We could go drink. You don't want to drink?
Wait, the captain would have pretty good stuff here. Honestly. I don't know, man. I don't want to get back.
Come on, dude.
I mean, what can we get?
It's all good.
Three clams.
Two clams. Oh, you got one too. We're even more set. Yeah. I mean, we bought entire meals with this.
Yeah, but you know, drinks always cost more than the meals.
You think so?
Dude, real life, no so. We've been here before. Dude, we got a rat for like a copper, and then the drink costs more than 10 rats.
Okay. It's all good though.
I mean, do we even know where the bars are at?
I don't think it's a good idea.
I don't know, man.
This place is nice.
Yeah, but you losing your clothes in this environment and that, I don't know, man. I don't.
You tell me to take my clothes off.
Say goodbye to your ass virginity.
Dude, there's gonna be some lonely woman that's gonna entice you. It ain't gonna be cricket. Like,
you're gonna lose your ass virginity.
Oh, what?
Well, let's just say you might end up being the pool boy without the pool.
And with the stick shoved up your ass.
It's, what? I don't swing that way. You know that.
Bro. You get fucked up and you can't rage out. Get your head on straight.
Can't rage out? Come on.
Yeah. Dude, look how mellow you are. Try raging out just, right now.
I don't need
to.
You
can do it. Yes.
If you really want to see it.
Yeah, do it. Do it. Rage out.
It's just what?
I get into the Super Saiyan power up stance and scream.
Yeah. But you can't do it.
What do I roll, Uriel?
You can't do it.
You're going to try to rage?
Yeah.
Best looking with your strength.
Just random.
Let's look at with your strength.
14.
He looks like he's taking a bad.
I need to raise my voice.
Okay, raise it. You're not really raging, bro.
You hear him getting mad. You can hear him starting to rage.
Just watch.
It just sounds like you're taking a random poop like you do in the morning.
Look at this.
And just he like... goes out into full rage mode. Like you see his eyes go red. Hold on. You see his eyes go red, his veins start to pop out, and he is naked.
The fuck that happened? Why, you're as naked as the day you were born, sir.
Wait, Yuri, I thought you said he couldn't rage.
He forced it.
Oh, damn.
Power level.
But he's
scaling.
Now naked.
He's now naked. Well, looks like you're prepped to go on the bars and get yourself some free drinks.
His clothes are all gone.
Okay, I'm going to use one of my actual rages. Rage, I'm going to lower it. All right.
It is
gone. Some clothes on. God, jeez, I didn't need to see that.
Hey, this is how we get free drinks.
This is how it's done.
He's not in a good state of mind right now. This is bad.
Look.
He's asking to get raped.
If they want him to put clothes on, they have to pay him to put clothes on.
He's basically walking around with a giant neon sign over his head saying, I consent to anything you do to me right now, bitches. Like, no. I'm not letting him go out there. This is against his better judgment.
I think that my rage would have...
He's raging.
His body, my free drink.
He's going to do what he wants to do.
Yeah.
I'm of
clear mind, but I'm also of rage mind. So I would assume I cleared out the calmness, right?
Yeah. No, the clothes are gone.
Yeah, I literally burned them off me.
That was a waste of how many clams?
I don't notice you say anything. Some screaming. All right.
Oh my God, calm your tits, bro. Calm your tits.
Is there anything around me that's an inanimate object?
Yeah.
You are right now looking
at the table, the chair, the poles holding up the ship.
I'm going to stand on the table.
I don't recommend. Why are we doing this?
I'm jumping
on
the table.
Are you on crack? What is wrong with you?
I don't hear you.
The captain lands on Kron's shoulder and goes, do I need to handle your friend, or are you going to handle that?
Okay, fuck it. Fuck it. I'm gonna cast some sort of fucking spell here. Hang on. I'm gonna find it. He's just he needs to calm down for his own safety.
Hey, fine. We're going out. If you plug.
No.
I hear the drinks and I.
Here, let's wait. Let me. I'm gonna just do this for information here.
Captain, do you want to come with us for drinks?
I need you to handle the situation up there, Karun.
Can I roll to
I'm
notice?
I'm charming him.
Can I roll to notice I hear him say drinks?
No one said drinks.
He said, Mag said drinks.
I just asked the captain if he wanted to go out with us for drinks.
I guessed it. I'm charm person.
Palm How do I counter ass. This? Is there a counter to it?
Well, you have to roll a saving throw.
What type?
Wisdom.
He
has to roll a wisdom save.
Son of a.
Yeah, you definitely failed that.
Drinks. I'm standing on the table. Drinks.
Well, okay.
Magica, Magica, and Babagadoo. You're going to be calm now. That's what I say to you. Cast.
Okay, how do I react to this, Cereal?
It's like you're coming out of being raped, being pissed. Oh. Just...
Well, you know, the funny thing is...
It doesn't work on rage.
The charmed creature regards you as a friendly acquaintance. We're already friends, right? Like,
yeah.
I don't know that charm person does anything here.
Oh, it's not a full control, right?
No. Yeah, they just they regard you as a friendly. But what I can do is I can cast command.
That's the one where you give it where you tell them what to do.
Yeah.
Navarre, you grab Lily onto your shoulders and go, drinks.
I don't know.
What the fuck?
Hold on. I wouldn't do that. I wouldn't touch her.
You're charmed.
Well, I'm going to cast command. So make another wisdom saving throw.
Okay. 20.
Yuri.
Fuck.
Damn. Oh, damn.
All right.
Yuri, what time is it?
It's evening.
Evening still.
Are we going to pull out of port soon? Like,
we're leaving in the morning.
Okay, we're leaving now.
I'm surprised. No purple magic.
Don't you dare incite the purple magic. Don't give any ideas.
You guys don't really like the purple magic.
Calm yourself. Calm yourself. It's okay.
You sure you don't want me to try purple magic calming?
Everything was gonna be all right. Don't worry about a thing.
Can I roll for perception if I heard Mag say drinks?
Sure. Gonna be all right.
21. I noticed Mag say drinks.
Definitely heard it.
No. I worked so hard on that spell, goddammit. Subdue.
Stay on that side.
Well.
Stay on that side.
Stay what?
He's talking to somebody.
Oh.
You have no other
Do you
idea
relax
what
now that you heard drinks?
Yeah. And I look down. What do I see?
It's your naked body.
Whoa.
On top of the table?
Yeah.
You look over to Whiskers on...
Oh.
Kron's shoulder and he has a blade out.
Dude, if we're getting drinks, I should put some clothes on.
But
yeah.
You know, every time You're we get drunk, something out. Blows up. I don't know if this is a good idea.
Look, it's a tradition.
No, it's not a tradition. That's only if we keep repeating it, and we don't need to repeat it.
I'm good.
No, you're not.
Just let me put some clothes on.
Good lord. Oh my god, naked
just
men
real
running
clothes,
around here.
Not clothes that you bought at the
don't know what happened to those.
They melted.
Melted?
They vaporized off your...
Oh, I did have chaps earlier.
Parts of his body are that color, by the way.
Oh, no.
That's not good.
I think it's stuck onto me. I'll take a shower. I'll clean up later. Mag, you still want a drink?
Yeah. What?
Nice. I'm going to get the clothes for my bag and put them on. I'm not putting in my armor on. I'm just putting on my underclothes, which is... Let me see. Traveler's clothes, which is boots, breeches, belt, shirt with a vest, and I'm not going to use a cloak.
All right, all the alcohol bars are on the same tier that you're at right now.
Okay. Nice. Who else is going with us?
Jalan, you going?
I can't take a weapon up in there.
Yeah, you can.
You're at zero tier.
Oh. Well, if we're at zero tier, I guess I can go to the bar.
Yeah, I got two clams. We'll see what we can get for this. I'll hand Zalan the other clam, unless Crown wants it.
Well, there's different bars. There's different bars with different themes.
Okay.
One of the bars is like a hot... It's like a hot tub, pretty much.
Oh.
Yeah, that's that.
Like, you get down there, you don't... It goes up to, like, your waist, kind of, and you sit at the bar.
Oh.
But it's...
Like the Kalahari?
Yeah.
Yeah. More convention stuff.
The other bar looks more like a tiki bar.
Okay. Well, I've got shirt glued to my body. I don't know if I should dirty their water. But I mean, if you want to go in there, we can. Vote. Who wants tiki bar? Who wants hot tub?
I kind of vote for tiki bar.
Okay, tiki bar. Kron?
Get up to the tiki bar, like, hey, how are you doing? What can I get you for you?
We got a few, we have some clams, a little bit. Which, what can you do for one clam?
Oh, you want the special, huh?
Sure.
You tourists always wants the specials. I bring you specials right now.
Okay, I give him my clam.
He brings like 6 margaritas.
Nice.
Ooh.
I love margaritas. How do you know?
All of them have a salt rim on it. They're all decorated on top.
There we go.
God damn it, now I want one in real life.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Huzzah.
Clank.
Cheers. As he grabs the 6th one.
Zalan, I gave you the other clam if you want to use it.
All right, what can I get to drink for one clam?
You want the special?
Sure, the special.
Bring it's a giant fishbowl.
It's the 6 drinks.
Okay, no, this is bad. No, all of us are going to drink 6 drinks?
Oh, okay. No, we're sharing them. So we have 12 total at the moment.
I need everybody to do a con save.
Oh, Lord.
God. What if we only want to drink one of them?
Yeah.
Yeah.
They don't need a con save.
More for right. No far.
These are loaded.
Yeah.
God. Did I go?
Lily lives. Zalan sober. Karan is
drunk. Zalan is drunk.
He Meg rolled is drunk. Three times.
I didn't mean to roll three times.
Oh.
Let's take the first one.
Which would be 21.
20. All right, we'll take the 21. You're
not drunk. Novar got a 16.
You are not drunk. So it's just Lily and Meg that are drunk.
Wait, I'm drunk?
Lily got a 20.
I'm sorry. Kron. Oh, Kron. Kron is drunk. What type of drunk are you? Or do we have to roll for what type of drunk are you?
I mean, we already know what kind of drunk I am.
He's a blows things up kind of drunk.
Oh.
A curious kind of drunk.
I'm an anti-authoritarian drunk. But this is a very peaceful place, so obviously I have no problems here.
Yeah. About Mag.
Because we didn't go up any further, so we wouldn't know how bad the place is further up.
True.
So, I don't know. Kron will probably just want to go to bed.
Meg? I'm happy. I'm content. I just smile and I'm quiet. I had the sudden urge to buy a house.
Can you do me
In game or in real life?
Can you do a sleight of hand for me? Meg? Okay. So all you guys are enjoying the drinks. They are, it feels like they all have double shots in them.
Mm-hmm.
And the bartender's just joking around, laughing with you guys.
Like the tequila sunrises from last night?
I don't even want to talk about that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
So they're just laughing and having a great time with you. Another like group shows up there too. And they're like, "Hey, how you doing?
Good.
You want to do some drinks?
We don't have too many clams left."
Oh, don't worry. She puts down 5 clams.
Whoa.
Load it up, bartender, and this clam is for you.
Wow.
So he load the next set are like really. They got 4 shots in them.
Oh man.
So all you guys just got another drink.
Okay. Are we rolling for this one?
Yes.
Ooh, perfect. 24.
You're
if
good.
Only I got that earlier.
Are we all rolling again?
Yep.
If you're drinking.
Yeah, they just gave you another round.
All right.
The other group that's there just chit-chatting with you guys.
I ask them, "What are you here for? Are you a local?"
Vacation.
Ah, good place for that?
Oh, yeah, nice, relaxing place. Very stress-free.
Yeah, I felt that when I was wearing that. Is he wearing the clothes?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I had that clothes on, too, for a while. Definitely feel you there.
You need to relax a bit, son.
I try.
Okay. They blow some smoke into you.
Oh. Oh,
roll,
no.
Wisdom.
Oh, boy. Perfect 22.
You don't get affected by it.
Yeah. Ooh, I'm used
They're
to
like,
it.
They're like, "Oh, we come from a major town."
On this island?
No. We come from the mainland.
Oh.
Yeah, we were doing pretty good, and then we had a shop like right by this university, and It just blew up one night.
That's rough.
And our shop just took a bunch of damage, so we've been having to close it for a minute.
Dang.
So we kind of went on a vacation just to relieve our stress.
That makes sense.
Yeah, it'll be a couple months before we can open it back up again.
Oh, I feel you.
I raise my glass in condolence.
Yeah. I'll do that too, and the clank.
Okay.
Hopefully it works out.
Clank with you. Oh yeah.
Just need this nice vacation, get my mind off of stuff.
And that is our cue to leave.
They kind of wave at you. Bye.
See ya. Thanks for the drink.
The rest of you notice that Meg has stolen one of the plants from the tiki bar.
God damn it, Meg.
But I did it really well, though.
The bar did not notice it.
Oh, boy.
What the rest of yous did.
And where are we going to put this?
Well, I'm just going to put it in my room.
Memento. As what's done is done.
We're already out. That's a go.
It's now a seafaring plant.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You make it
our
back.
Portable water we're going to put on this plant. That's probably. All right.
You make it back to the boat. And the night, you all go to sleep for the night as the new security guards are taking turns patrolling the ship.
Before I sleep, I'm going to try to clean up and get that stuff off of me.
You find that it's reformed back.
The clothes?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. I'm going to take it off.
You find yourself having a hard time. It's like peeling your skin off.
Okay. Man, this stuff is weird.
I won't get a way to remove a curse for several levels. So,
do you wish to try to use your strength to remove it?
Yeah.
Okay. Roll strength.
13.
Still on you. Dang it. It feels like you're pulling your skin off, but it's not coming off.
What the heck?
I could always try purple magic.
I think that sounds like a really bad idea.
Oh, I'm stripping in front of everyone?
Trying to, but...
Yeah, like you haven't done that before.
Hey, this stuff is still on me. I'm trying to pull it off, but it's not coming off. That's too bad, because I like the clothes.
I think I could get it off with fucking purple magic.
I mean...
I really do.
Can we do it off the ship? Yeah. I don't want to do it on the ship.
I mean, it doesn't matter to me.
Okay, let's go off the ship. You want to step off the ship? Yeah, let's go off the ship. We're going to go off the ship.
All right.
A fair distance, so we're not within range, hopefully, of the ship.
You're on the beach.
Okay.
Probably good. Any explosion will get dampened by the sand.
Dude, this is a nice beach.
A nine? What is the nine? I haven't got a nine yet.
I'm standing there T-posed.
I put my hand out and wave it and say, Pepper Magic Spell.
Here we go again.
It's always the purple magic.
Oh, excuse me.
Scroll up, scroll up, scroll up.
It ain't great.
Your energy comes out of your hand and makes Navarre glow.
Okay. It's
a bright light.
You're glowing. Did the glow help with the shirt?
You can't see him because of how bright he is right now. After it dims, after finally it clears out, Navarre, you're facing Navarre.
Okay.
Hey.
You see two Navarres.
I see two Navarres?
Uh-huh.
Do we have the same clothes on?
Are you both Navarres?
I'm Navarre.
They both say the same thing.
Oh, no. I don't know what I did.
Mm.
Maybe I should just try purple magic stuff again. It'll fix it.
I hide my plan.
I mean, two Navarres are better than one.
I don't know about that.
I mean, not wrong.
And the other one goes, I'm the real Navarre, as he does a pose.
You're lying, dude.
You stop.
Look at this pose.
That's weak.
Look at this hoe.
I don't need to cap you, though. I'm good.
Yeah, that's what something I think real Navarre would say, because he doesn't need to copy people.
Yeah. Zalan, you want to do another try?
I will do another try.
And I know he's not the real one, because there's no footsteps around him, because he just appeared.
Hmm.
I wave my hand and say, go, go, purple magic stuff.
Hmm.
17 this time.
You just increased his strength, dex, intelligence, wisdom, and charisma by 2.
Oh, nice.
For 1 minute.
Now you're more awesome.
Hmm, I feel it.
Yeah, I feel it too.
Let me try to pull off my shirt. Does it come off?
Oh, God.
Hmm?
Nope.
Bro. Now there are two bros.
The shirt's not coming off. Third time's the charm, Zalan.
Yeah. Third time's the charm. Go, go, purple magic stuff.
Good Lord.
19.
What were you trying to do again?
Remove
me? I'm trying to get the freaking the shirt off of him.
Yeah.
The shirt comes off of both of them.
Well, and the pants. And the shoes.
And the pants.
And he's naked again.
All of it comes off.
Why are you still there? Yeah, I'm naked. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really naked too here.
Why are you here?
Why are you here?
You're not me, so you should go.
I am me. You're not you.
I am me.
From what I can tell from most of my purple magic stuff, the magic stuff doesn't tend to last a very long time.
We can hope. I need to go put my clothes on.
Yeah, please.
I'm going to keep this stuff.
Don't put those clothes back on.
I want to keep them, though. Spank clams on them.
Yeah. Maybe you could sell them someplace.
Yeah, yeah. Do they still exist?
Oh, who left? Oh. No.
Oh, okay.
They're not. They fell. They came off you and then kind of just like dissolved in the ground.
Okay. All right. Now I'm going to go put my clothes on.
The one goes, you know we look good, right?
I agree, but it's weird having another me here. You know what I'm saying?
No, no, I get you. It's very off that I get to see another me here, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. But don't worry. He'll probably fade away soon.
Yeah.
I mean, if not, I could try, you know, some more purple magic stuff on him.
Right.
Yeah, you tried that pretty enough.
Yeah, you should do definitely do it on him.
No.
No. Stop.
I didn't move, so they should know that I'm the one.
When you got split,
mm-hmm.
you split from your original movement. One went right, one went left.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. To them, you both look alike.
Okay.
Yeah.
He puts his hand on your shoulder and goes, God, you look sexy.
That's not something I would say.
And but... then he fades away.
Oh, okay. Ooh, that was weird. Am I that weird?
Yes.
Yes and no.
Yes?
He said like that. While you were under the influence of the clothing? Yes. Uh-huh.
Oh. But he didn't have it at the end. So I need to self-reflect, is that what you're saying?
Maybe.
Oh.
Or, you know, obviously you can externally self-reflect, apparently.
Mm. Yeah, true.
I mean, everybody is their own person.
Yeah.
That's true.
Novar's turning, his blood, I think, is blue or something. I can't remember what Tiefling blood looks like, but I'm getting darker.
I know it's a color.
Yeah, I think it's a darker color. I think it's blue. So I'm getting more of a whatever color that would be.
Shades of blue.
Yeah.
So as you guys head back to the boat,
cheeks out. Cheeks out. Yeah, I'm going to go put my clothes on. Yep.
And we will leave it for there for tonight.
Okay. Appreciate it, Yuri.